that's probably where it stops being true.
Correct. That's the weed talking.
That's the weed talking.
I think the official term is burden of proof, right?
Yeah, right. The cops are like, oh, this is a little weird. We saw the thing fall, too. It was a falling star.
Speaking of other trippy, alcoholic, drug-infested, tattooed scumbag people, is it time for Florida news?
Girl.
And now, from North America's own land down under, it's time for Sunshine State News with your certified lifeguard, J.D. Ryan.
Here we go. Florida police officer was fired after he fled from a traffic stop in his police cruiser. Now, here is the interaction between the deputy and the fired officer, Alexander Shoney. This is cut number 4.
You going to pull over?
What? I am going into work, my man. Why are you trying to pull me over as I am going?
Because you're going 80 and a 45.
I am going into work.
Okay, where are you going to work?
What does it look like I am dressed for?
My name is Deputy Hilton, and they see your driver's license.
No.
10-4, I got a city, Orlando PD taking off from a traffic stop.
I like the kid. No.
No. What am I going to do? No. I'm a cop, too.
I'm going to work, my man.
Shoney was charged, by the way, with reckless driving, eluding police with lights and siren activated. And why would a cop pull over another cop? But anyway.
None of your business.
Speeding. None of my damn business.
None of your business, no.
Doing 80 and a 45.
G, have you ever been arrested for prostitution?
What?
No.
Have you ever been arrested at all?
No, I have not. Sorry to let you down, but I have not.
I was kidding about the prostitution part.
But you weren't kidding about the arrested part.
I mean, hell, it happens to the good people. Bad things happen to good people. I got arrested in Crowley, Texas when I was 19 years old. I mean, it was like slow pitch, though. Son, I hate that we have to do this. Are you sure you don't have the money? Unpaid traffic ticket in Amarillo.
Damn Amarillo, yeah.
Dumas, Texas is a bitch,
yes.
Dude.
Oh, yeah.
That's ski trips.
Witch hunt, man. That's a hoax trial. You've done nothing wrong.
It's a, hoax trial.
Well,
the Blair Witch Project.
One more Florida story. A Florida black...
But I was still talking.
I'm sorry, my bad.
What's up with you people?
We're just excited that you're here.
Son of a bitch. All right, I'm in the middle. What was I doing? I was getting arrested, right?
Yeah.
Right, JD, am I allowed to talk about it, or are you?
Mike, turn my mic on.
No. Okay, so I don't have much more to say about it. So They didn't put me in jail. They did take me to the police. I called my girlfriend at the time. I happened to have 400 cash in my room. She drove to my room, got the cash, brought it up, got me out. They didn't fingerprint me. So I got half-assed arrested.
So I got over to the Group W bench, and the guy says, what are you in for, kid? And I said, I didn't pay my traffic ticket in Amarillo. And they all moved away from me on the Group W bench.
So, I mean, as long as we're talking about Florida news, I thought this went along with those kind of stories. Go ahead, JD. Thanks.
Back up. I'm in timeout.
No, you're back up.
Oh, but wait, before he comes out of timeout, my good girlfriend almost got arrested. The sheriffs came looking for her.
Oh.
And her mom was like, yeah, they came looking for you. They said something about unpaid traffic tickets.
Yep.
So she hid out in my apartment the whole weekend because, you know, if you get locked up on Friday, you don't get out till Monday or Tuesday.
Yeah. And then she got arrested.
So she almost got arrested for traffic tickets.
JD.
A Florida black bear was found roaming the property at the International Airport in Tampa. Here's the Executive Vice President of Airport Operation talking about the intruder, the black bear. Cut number 5.
Cocaine
bear.
We
sprung into action. Our operations team, together with our police department, we went to the area. We set up a robust perimeter around the area. You know, it's the first time in our 50-plus year history that we know of that we've had a bear come onto the property.
This has been the week for bears.
At the airport?
At the airport.
Yeah. That's scary.
Yeah, they also had one show up at the beach this week, too. So black bears are everywhere.
I wanted to go and see
It's cocaine bear.
I wanted to go and see my sister up in Jacksonville.
You're going to fly?
Well, that's where you go if you won't catch a plane.
That is true.
I figured I'd sneak into the cargo hatch.
Oh, you're going to get on.
Before I got there, they nabbed me.
Weren't fast enough.
They moved me to what they called a more suitable habitat.
I see.
Suitable?
All right, where was
Son
that?
Of a bitch.
Where was that?
It's a long walk to the Winn-Dixie is what it is, outside of Ocala in the National Wildlife Refuge. Don't get me wrong, there's some nice girl bears out there, but there's no cocaine to be found.
Oh, you're part of the cocaine bear.
Well, all bears love cocaine.
Did not know that.
Cocaine?
Yeah.
Honey?
Honey.
Yeah.
Oh, a mix.
That's what we like.
I guess.
Don't ask me why.
Cocaine Bear, I've not watched your movie yet. Cocaine Bear's any good?
Oh, you like it.
Mm-hmm. How long
that was
it?
That was actually my cousin. Yeah.
An hour and 40
my
minutes.
My cousin Tom, he used to be a girl bear. Yeah, his name was Belinda. He doesn't look any different at all.
Did he change his identity?
Yeah.
What's he now?
What do you mean?
He said he used to be a girl bear.
Yeah, he's a boy bear now.
What's his name now?
Tom.
Oh, I wasn't listening close enough.
Ha. Huh. What causes, do you like cocaine too?
No.
You ever sit and listen to Steely Dan?
No.
Eat cocaine?
No.
Cut your waffles into three pieces and snort them?
No.
Boy, that's fun. You know what happened to me one time?
No, no, what?
When my cousin was still a boy, he had a wife, and she used to do her puzzles on my waffle spot. Boy, that pissed me off. I mean, you can't eat enough cocaine to make that not hurt your feelings. You waffle spots, you waffle spot. Son of a bitch. Anyway.
JD, do you have any more Florida
I'm news? Walking through the Winn-Dixie.
Thank God. We are out of Florida news. My name is John Clay. We'll buy cars on the radio for America's best car buyer. Give me the VIN.com. And it is summer nights now.
It's hot.
Yesterday was hot. It's going to be hot around Texas, hot around Florida, hot around the South. Hot, hot, hot. All right, if you're with a... Hot and wet. Okay, if you're with a woman, ain't worth a damn if you're in the jungle. Be right back.
Hi, this is Gigi with the John Clay Wolf Radio Show, brought to you by GiveMeTheVIN.com. GiveMeTheVIN.com will give you top dollar for your vehicle and pick it up. No hassles, no worries. Our Google reviews tell the story of happy customers coast to coast. Ready to sell your car? Go to GiveMeTheVIN.com. That's GiveMeTheVIN.com.
Sell us your car. GiveMeTheVIN.com. So easy you can do it.
Saturday morning from New York to Los Angeles to Houston and broadcasting to the rest of the world online at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolf.com. You're listening to the John Clay Wolf Show. Want more of the John Clay Wolf Show? Check out the largest radio show and fastest growing podcast at jcwshow.com.
seconds. Stand by.
Number one Saturday morning show. Hit them up. 800-800-RADIO. Want more of the John Clay Wolf Show? Check out the fastest growing podcast at jcwshow.com. Thanks for making us number one. Hello,
my love. Weather's crazy across the South today, this week, this month. Lots of rain. Lakes and reservoirs filling up all over the region. A large protective dike gave way this morning. What is a large protective dike, JD?
It's an area that keeps water from another area, or...
A woman in big platform shoes says, hey, you, don't go there.
Man, it's like we practiced that.
Oh, Jesus. Good morning, Vietnam. That was too damn funny. Gigi, how are your boobs?
They are still uneven, thank you very much.
Hmm. Well, we had a listener last week get so excited about that. For those of y'all that are unaware, and I don't know why it just started now, but it wasn't on at 8 o'clock, but our live video stream, you can see us now in the studio, so go to jcwshow.com, and you can click the play button, and it'll turn on the cameras for you. But we had a lot of feedback from your boob stories.
People are concerned about my breasts. Yeah,
a guy named Greg J actually sent us in a parody song about Gigi's dilemma, having one breast smaller than the other.
One way or
an anomaly that we talked about last week on the John Clay Wolf Show. Here's cut number two to remind you.
Back to boobs. Gigi, have you ever thought about getting a boob job?
I would like to have one, and I am willing to subject myself to one if anyone wants to pay for it.
Well, this is easy. I mean, we're on all over the country. Plastic yeah. surgeon guy wants a plug. Yes. Give Gigi some boobs.
Yes, yes. Make them symmetrical and perky. You know what I mean?
What size would you go?
Well, I have one side that's a double D already, so I just like them to match.
Was it always that way, or did one just lose a little?
Yes, it's always been a whole cup size smaller on the left than on the right.
So, that's right. How do you buy bras if one cup size is different?
Well, you have a choice to make. You can have this extra breast right here, which gives a little cleavage.
So the right one's the big one?
And this one is a whole cup size smaller. So because this one is overflowing, this means this cup size fits.
So what is a girl to do? Well, luckily, Greg J had some words of encouragement, put together a little song for you, Gigi. You ready?
This
is
to ready.
The tune of Money by Pink Floyd, cut number three.
Gigi, you're so cool. A sexy voice on the air making all of us guys drool. Gigi, oh my sweet hun, it's fine that one boob's a little bigger than the other one. If you ask me, you're just as fine as you can be with right a D and left a C. Gigi.
Who did that?
Guy named Greg J.
Oh my God, I love it.
That's pretty solid.
Yeah.
I love it. I still want matching boobs though, but I love it.
Parody songs about Gigi's boobs.
Isn't that great? Well,
that's when you know you've hit the big time.
Awesome. I know. You know what I mean? I just need to take it all in. I'm having a moment. Thank you.
Wow, the video stream just doubled. The people watching going.
Well, on one channel's heavier than the other. Mm. It's in stereo.
So if Gigi wore a Budweiser shirt with a big one on the right and the little one on the left, the shirt would read, "This Bud's for you."
That's right. That's right. Budweiser. That's right. It would have to be MGD, though.
Remember when I told y'all the term drag queen was going to wind up getting in trouble?
Yeah. What?
Remember I said the term drag queen? You know there's a lot of words now that are not okay. Little people replaced the MG.
I wasn't aware of it.
You weren't aware of what?
That it was like a term.
What wasn't a term?
That was like a
what's it? What's
questionable
it?
Term.
What's it?
I hadn't heard what you're saying, but I ignored.
I said I think the word drag queen will wind up getting on the ineligible list somehow.
And you're probably right.
Well, I'm just guessing. You know?
I ignore that stuff anyway, like, you know.
But drag shows have been getting heavily protested in the past week.
Oh, God, yeah. It's all over the place.
Now, why are they being protested? What's the problem?
Because they're too fun.
Yeah, they
just
are.
Too fun.
Have you ever been to one?
No, I see them on TV.
I have. They're funny and fun and hilarious.
Why are they funny and fun?
Because it's guys all dressed up that look just like women, and they come out like Cher and Barbra Streisand, mm-hmm. and they sing to the song. It's a great show, and everybody's having a good time.
Has anybody on the show dressed in drag before?
Oh, geez.
I did one time. Parks and Rec in the town I started radio in had like their annual deal, and they had something called the drag.
You were like in a small country town. I'm surprised this went over smooth.
Right. They had something called the drag race, and they would match us up, male and female, employees, all right, co-workers. And I remember Rosie had to wear like a big oversized jacket and a tie, and I had to wear like a one-piece onesie country dress and a bonnet hat. And it was drag race. And we were like, it was like a sack race, but dressed as the opposite sex. Yeah.
I'm surprised. Okay. All right. There's one. Anybody
and
else?
Number two.
Two? JD? Yeah.
Actually, I did it on television, though, so I don't think it really
is
bad. Yeah. Russ Martin and I had a TV show. We were out in Las Vegas, and we made this big bet with this guy. And if we lose, we'll wear a dress walking down the strip in Vegas. And, of course, we lose the bet, and we're walking down the strip in drag.
Do you feel comfortable in it?
I did, actually. It was my wife's dress, and it was really, really comfortable.
It fit you? She must have been a big old gal.
I was actually a smaller guy.
And, that's
a jam. I just felt pretty. I just felt pretty.
And number three?
Oh, you?
That would be me.
Ah,
yeah.
What?
So there was this band on a radio station that I worked on that, you know, you do songs and stuff. And I'm a big No Doubt fan.
I like her too.
Oh, yeah. So I dressed as Gwen Stefani, singing this song in front of thousands of people.
Where?
This is out with a band, a former station I worked at. And this was, golly, it was Joe Pool Lake in Grand Prairie, Texas.
Oh, yeah.
Live event out. And I'll never forget. I mean, I had the lipstick, the fake boobs, the crop top showing my belly. I mean, it was blonde hair.
What age?
This was 2002. So
20 years ago.
Yeah.
So 29?
Yeah, just right before 30, yeah. And I remember sitting up the stage doing the song and doing the whole motions and everything and looking dead in the stands and seeing my friend just, his mouth was like, what the hell what is going done? On?
It can be off-putting.
And the scariest
thing. Gigi, what?
I looked like my mom. Oh, it was so weird. I was like, this is not good.
That is weird, man.
Huh. Anyway.
I'm sorry you had that experience.
So all of us, but John, never in drag?
My sister dressed me in drag when I was a little kid. Is that what you call it back then?
Yeah, no, you can get assaulted by a bunch of older girls when you're a kid.
Yeah.
Do that, yeah.
Definitely my sister would dress me in drag when I was about four. I've seen the pictures. If that's what you call it. I don't know. Gigi, what was the thing you were talking about? Speaking of weird dress and weird things, three guys getting swept out to sea on an inflatable duck.
Yeah, they decided to go and see what would happen. So they and there's a picture of it. I'll send you the picture. They got swept out and had to be rescued on a big, giant, it looks like a big bathtub duck.
Huh.
It's really funny to me.
Like what swept out and how far and how bad? Like did they wind up in Cuba?
No, they didn't wind up in another country. They just had to get rescued. They were way far out further than they thought they were going to be.
That'll happen.
It's just a funny picture.
My son, when he was really little, I bought him this inflatable duck thing, and we were out at the beach, you know, on a freshwater lake,
mm-hmm.
and the wind picked up, and his duck starts sailing away, so I go swim after it. And I get like 40 yards out there, man, and I haven't got the duck yet, and I'm wondering if I'm going to be able to get back. And thank God, some guys in a bass boat came by and got the duck, came over and gave it to me. And then they rowed away, and I'm still 40 yards out, man. And thank God they handed me the duck.
Why is it called a bass boat? Well, I mean, why isn't a catfish boat?
It's just a term I use because I'm an ignorant
uses
person.
It. Everybody uses it.
Because I don't know what to say.
Everybody uses it.
I say bass boat.
I just wonder where that came from.
Probably just a boat.
It's a boat that they go fishing in, and it's bass.
No, but everybody
cool.
calls them bass.
But bass, because bass is cool.
They crappie, were definitely fishing, man. One
crappie
guy
boat's
was,
not cool. Not
one
cool.
guy was in the bow, and he had that. You know,
what
he had
about
his chair.
A redfish boat?
Catfish, not cool. Redfish, catfish. Not cool.
What? Gigi, what is catfishing?
Well, catfishing is when you know what catfishing.
I mean,
is.
I kind of do. Let me think. It's like when you act like you're prettier than you are.
No, it's like my good girlfriend who. She would call me. She's like, girl, we got to go to the gym. I'm like, what are you talking about? I'm about to meet this guy, see? And I need to lose like 75 pounds in a day. What are you talking about? She would send them pictures from a long time ago, like when she was in high school. And so it was a slimmer version. You know what I mean?
Right.
So, yeah. That would definitely be catfishing. Uh-huh.
But I mean, how did that term come to be? Like you're fishing with the wrong, with fake bait.
In the modern age. People mm-hmm. do that on the internet where they try to draw you out of something. Catfishing today refers to how guys will go to the riverbank and stick their whole arm in there and pull that catfish out.
That's noodling.
Noodling.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah. So catfishing online is where you like sneak up next to somebody and then you reach in their hole and grab them and pull them out.
Just get them by any
Sounds
means
dirty.
Necessary. I know a guy's hatfish.
It is.
You know what I mean? If you see pictures of a guy on a dating website and he's always wearing a hat, there's a problem. There is a problem.
Homeboy ain't got no effing hair.
Exactly.
It's a problem.
Yeah. Kenny Chesney. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you never see him without a hat.
Yeah.
Bald.
Bald and gay. Good morning, everyone. My name is John Clay Wolf. This is the John Clay Wolf Show. It's brought to you by America's Best Car Buyer, GiveMeTheVIN.com. GiveMeTheVIN.com buys cars online, 1,000 a week. You can go to GiveMeTheVIN.com, put in your license plate number, your VIN number, answer a couple of quick questions. You'll have an instant bid in 30 seconds. It's very, 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 very quick. We'll come to your house. You can go to one of our many locations across the country at GiveMeTheVIN.com. And if GiveMeTheVIN does not beat a written CarMax offer, they'll send you a check for $100. The show is also brought to you by Gordon Boswell's Flowers. Around the country or around the corner, Gordon Boswell's Flowers is your go-to florist. And you can see the link to both of those at jcwshow.com, where you can also see the live video feed that right now, if you want to watch us in the studio, or later this afternoon or next week, you can pull down the podcast of the show, which has all the music and the commercials stripped out. After this musical interlude, we will be back with more, and I want to talk about Trump and Fox News and Tucker Carlson. There's a lot of things going on this week in politics. I'm not going to get all deep, but it's pretty weird. Pretty weird. Be right back.
Special people change. How many tiny lives are living strange. Where were you while we were getting high? Slowly walking down the hall, faster than a cannonball. Where were you while we were getting high? Someday a champagne supernova in the sky. Someday you will find me caught beneath the landslide. In a champagne supernova, a champagne supernova in the sky. Up the dawn and ask her why. A dream, she never dies.
Hey, Gigi. Can you just read something real quick? We're going to do some adjustments on yours.
I can do that. Let me see. What do I want to read? Emergency crews responded to a swarm of bees in Los Angeles, and when a volunteer got to the scene, he was overwhelmed and collapsed while on camera. The man was eventually able to walk out of the situation when uniformed officers showed up. Cut 21.
Keep going.
A Las Vegas family is claiming that they saw a UFO and it literally landed in their backyard, and that they saw tall aliens with big eyes, not big asses, just big eyes, come out of it. Here is some audio from their 911 calls and interactions between responding officers and witnesses. Cut 22. You want me to keep going?
Yep, one more.
Paul McCartney just finished working on an old John Lennon demo called Now and Then. It should be out later this year. Here's a bit of John's 1978 demo, cut 23.
One more, sorry.
Now here's what's most notable about Paul's plan to produce a new Beatles song. Okay. Out of that. It seems a YouTuber beat him to the punch, and he used artificial intelligence to make it. See what you think. Cut 24.
We're good, G. Thanks.
Okay.
Studios. It's time for the John Clay Wolf Show, presented by GiveMeTheVin.com. Call John toll free, cheap bastards, 1-800-800-RADIO, and check out the podcast at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolf.com.
Gigi, did you see where your boy got arrested?
Who, my boy Trump?
Yep.
You know, okay, yeah. I think it was like 37 counts. When will you people learn? You get your panties all in a snit. You're just like, oh my God, he got arrested. They're going to get him this time. They do not call him the Teflon Don for nothing.
Did you see Tucker Carlson's comments on
John
Twitter?
John Gotti was the Teflon Don.
What did he say?
Hey, it's Tucker Carlson. On Tuesday afternoon, the Biden administration had Donald Trump arrested. It was a pretty big news story. You may have seen it. Just before 9 p.m. that night, as part of its coverage, Fox News ran two live video feeds next to one another. On the right, Donald Trump addressed his supporters in New Jersey. On the left, Joe Biden spoke at an event for the Secretary General of NATO in Washington. Beneath those videos at the bottom of the screen, Fox's banner read this way, quote, "Wannabe dictator speaks at the White House after having his political rival arrested."
That's pretty heavy.
Gotcha.
That is right up there with the time the airplane crashed in San Francisco and to put the horrible pilot names up. This is greatness.
Bing dong ow.
Yeah.
So the producer puts "wannabe dictator speaks at the White House after having his political rival arrested."
Yeah, it lasted about 40 seconds before they pulled it down.
The guy's fired, obviously. Hang on a second.
Yeah.
Those words were up for less than 30 seconds, but the effect was immediate. Inside Fox, the women who run the network panicked. First, they scolded the producer who put the banner on the screen. Less than 24 hours after that, he resigned. He'd been at Fox for more than a decade. He was considered one of the most capable people in the building.
Now, this is so interesting to me. Tucker Carlson is owned by Fox. They pay him, okay?
Still.
They took him off the air. He's still getting paid. JD, you and your band sign a deal with A&M Records.
Alrighty.
Okay. And they decide to quit making your albums, but they're going to keep paying you through the contract.
Right.
So you go over to Casablanca Records. I'm showing my age.
There you go.
And you decide to cut a new record.
Sure.
So Tucker's getting paid by Fox, and he gets with Elon Musk, and they start a Twitter channel. So Tucker's image, his face, his freedom of speech, is he allowed to speak? Is he doing a show? Well, if you look at it on Twitter, he's sitting in front of a camera talking. He happens to talk with his inflection and his up and down. And hi, da-da-da, I'm Tucker Carlson. You know, he does have a tie on. Does this change anything?
We're going to redefine what broadcasting
That's
is.
That's right. That's right.
That's exactly what it is.
So here's what I'm looking at. I'm like, this is ballsy. Fox has plenty of money. Tucker has plenty of money, but he doesn't. But he probably doesn't have the balls. A lot of guys like that don't have the balls to take on big corporations legally. Now I'm talking like Tucker. By the way,
there you go.
Look, I'm channeling my inner Tucker.
You'd be more like, well, they can't take him on legally. The corporation. What if I took him on legally as a corporation? I'm just asking questions.
You got to do a manic laugh. There you go.
So he wants to do his own thing. He's bound by Fox. He can't. Elon talks him in. He and Elon get together and decide to start the Tucker Show on Twitter, but they don't really call it a real show. He doesn't have guests. He doesn't have producers. He's just talking to
his
camera.
I'm just talking, man.
So what's the risk? What's wrong with it? Well, we're going to get our ass sued off. That's what's wrong with it, Elon. Here's my theory. Elon says, I'll cover your legal bill. Because I need you to bring all... Why you roll your eyes at me? Hmm? What the hell are you and your eye rolling? You don't think... You're the eye rollingest bitch.
I'm not rolling a damn
If I wanted to have my eyes rolled out, I'd have had my wife
my
over here.
As if to agree with you. Genius.
Reckless eyeballing. Big pimping.
So, who's going to cover the legal bill? That's the real issue here. Because, I mean, this legal bill, they could rack it up to $1 million. You know, I mean, just cover him in legal.
They can cover it.
Cover him in legal.
They can cover it.
Fox can. So Tucker going out here and taking on a train quietly, who's covering the legal bill? Elon.
He and Elon. Can both cover.
Elon's covering.
Brilliant.
I'll bet your ass that's what's going
on. You're right. You're 100% right.
Why not?
Well, look at what it's bringing to Twitter. A lot of action. And he spends most of the time. So this is the fourth episode. And he spends a lot of the time just bagging on Fox. Listen.
He offered to stay for the customary 2 weeks, but Fox told him to clear out his desk and leave immediately. Then the company issued a public apology for the 27-second long wannabe dictator line. Quote, "The Chyron was taken down immediately," Fox's PR department said, and then added ominously, it was, quote, "addressed." That was all true, but it was not enough to save Fox News from the ensuing scandal. For a time in the rest of the media, Fox's assessment of Donald Trump's arrest seemed to overshadow Trump's arrest itself. Suggesting that Biden is a dictator, declared the Washington Post, quote, "crossed the line." Alexander Vindman agreed strongly. Vindman is the perennial MSNBC guest and full-time Ukraine promoter you may remember from Russiagate. On Twitter, he demanded that the Pentagon pull Fox News from all military bases. It is, quote, "absolutely unacceptable for American Forces Network to carry programming that directly, spuriously, attacks the commander-in-chief of American Armed Forces," Vindman wrote. In other words, Joe Biden must ban all criticism of himself because that's what non-dictators do. John
blah, 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 blah.
So this guy's not only breaking his contract, he's got 80 million people watching him do this, and he's nanny-nanny boo-booing Fox.
He's just doing what he does, man.
Yeah, but it's going to... I mean, I just would love to see the legal wrangling.
Fox News sucks.
That's a drop. I don't think it sucks. I think it's...
No, it does.
I think
it
all does. I think all news sucks.
Yeah, they all can. They're
except
all capable
the local
of it.
News.
They're all capable of it.
Well, anyway. Yeah, that's my theory, is that Elon's covering Tucker's legal bill, because there's no way he's got the cojones to go out and do this on his own.
What's the worst thing that can happen?
Is get your ass sued off, and it cost you $10 million.
Right, but Elon's going to cover it. But if Elon can't, Tucker can cover it himself. He's going to cover it. It's not the end of the world. People ought to just calm down, man.
I agree with that. You know, calm.
Just watch
down.
Whatever you like to watch.
Do what Gigi
but
said.
But from a business, I mean, you know, you hire somebody as your contracted singer. You pay him a gazillion dollars.
I know.
And now they're going to go sing over on Elon's platform?
I know. It's like...
Why, you're paying them?
It's like the
I think they
joke.
Should immediately quit paying him.
The woman...
I think that Fox should... Fox should immediately quit paying Tucker. Let him sue them for breach.
They could. The woman finds a snake in the road, and he's been stepped on and run over by a truck. She picks him up and takes him home and nurses him and feeds him and brings him back to health, and he bites her. And she goes, "Hey, I helped you out. Why'd you bite me?" He's like, "Lady, you knew I was a snake when you picked me up."
Hey, so who's the snake?
Fox News.
Oh, okay.
He's getting religious weird.
Not Tucker.
Well, Al Pacino's baby's already here?
Yeah.
That was quick.
That was quick.
Yeah,
we got Al Pacino's knocked up his granddaughter's friend's friend, and then all of a sudden the baby's already here.
Like a week later after they announced it, the baby is already here, which apparently inspired Chelsea Handler to post this Instagram message calling out Al Pacino, Robert De Niro, Alec Baldwin, and even Elon Musk. Here is her post, cut number 6.
A new epidemic sweeping the country, and no, it's not another virus, it's worse. Horny old men who won't stop spreading their seeds. They cannot stop procreating. Between the four of those guys, they have 32 children. Robert De Niro just had his 7th child at the tender age of 79. So how do we protect the women of the world from horny old men? I'm offering to put myself up for auction for any available octogenarians. You can find me on eBay or DoorDash. Actually, maybe all these old men should put themselves up for auction. After all, they are antiques. Horny old men, it's never worth the money.
Okay, so wait. You know Robert De Niro, he likes the chocolate, right?
Right. Oh, he does. He's got a black wife.
Yeah, he got a whole bunch of black women and black kids, too. So we have to leave him out of that.
All right, coming up next is the car segment, where you call in 800-800-7234. 800-800-7234. 800-800-RADIO is what that spells out. Give me year, make, model, miles, average, rough, or clean. And remember, we're having our classic sale coming up, an auction at the end of this month. And you can go to JCW Show for more information on that. Classics mean old cars. So I'm buying old cars more than normal. Old cars, meaning K5 Blazers, old Vets, old Ferraris, T-Buckets, High Boy Roadsters, all that stuff. GiveMeTheVin.com is who sponsors this show. And that's who I'm going to bid these cars for in a minute. So anything I say, what I'll pay you for the car, the money's good at GiveMeTheVIN.com. That makes me their bitch boy. I'm spokesman, right? Hey, I can say that. They're not going to get mad at me. 800-800-7234. 800-800-RADIO. Call in now. Year, make, model, miles, average, rough, or clean. Year, make, model, miles, average, rough, or clean. I'll say 10 grand, 20 grand, 100 grand, whatever the number is. I'll bet them quick. While we're waiting during this next song that we're going to break to, load the phones up. I'll take your call to air as soon as we come back. We'll do a quick 2-3 minute fire drill, lightning round, on the cars. Some people love the cars. Some people hate the cars. The cars are coming up. So if you hate them, come back in a minute after it's over. If you love them, stay tuned. Be right back.
Some people say syndicated shows aren't that good because they don't have that local feel.
Right.
But you don't skyrocket to the number one weekend spot by sucking. Hey, the largest radio show and fastest growing podcast, The John Clay Wolf Show. Go to jcwshow.com.
down, hold there, make sure you're off Bluetooth and your radio's down. Stand by.
Now, back to the John Clay Wolf Show. Hit him up right now, 1-800-800-RADIO. This is the John Clay Wolf Show.
And this is where I snap bid a bunch of cars for GiveMeTheVIN.com. John in Virginia, you've got a classic car. What is it? John in Virginia, you have a classic car. What is it? I mean, is this thing...
John!
Is it still didn't work? Don in Clearwater, yeah, I'm Florida. Here. Hey, Don, you there? 72 Bug.
Hello.
Can you not hear me? Sean, no more food for you in night until this works. Rosemary. Shit. Rosemary. No, it doesn't work. The mic doesn't work with the phone.
Rosemary, you hear him?
No, she doesn't hear me.
Rosemary, you hear me?
Hang on. Maybe it's this deal. Did you practice this? Rosemary, can you hear me now? Rosemary, can you hear me now?
I don't think she can hear me either. So
no. The phones don't work.
Well, she's listening to radio.
No, I mean, it's not her fault. She can't hear me.
Try one more.
The thing doesn't work. Jesus Christ. Andy. No, it doesn't work.
Andy.
No, it doesn't work. Bob, will you say Andy?
Andy,
he can't hear. They can hear.
Huh. Something's off.
Well, I mean, there's nothing better than spending $1 gazillion on this studio and having a guy live here for 6 weeks and it doesn't work.
It did work this morning.
Yeah, that's cool. I mean, that's what the pilot said when he crashed at the end of the runway.
I know.
I'm sorry everybody died, but it was working right this morning. Okay. Well, thank you guys for your time. And,
oh, no.
No, you can't quit the show. We still have a lot of show left.
Well,
mail from jail's coming up, John.
All prisoners, please call in now. We'll have great conversations. Yeah, that's the only way we can communicate with anybody is from snail mail because our phone system doesn't work. Well, this is cool.
We're old school.
Yeah. All right. We'll be right back.
Broadcasting on air, online, anywhere you are with a smartphone and an internet connection. Check out the podcast. JCWShow.com or JohnClayWolf.com.
Check.
It's so faint.
Right. It's been that way since the day you installed it.
Check.
1, 2, 1, 2.
No, it's everybody.
Right.
Just fly.
We now return to the John Clay Wolf Show. Presented by GiveMeTheVin.com. Call in 800-800-RADIO and check out the podcast at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolf.com. This is the John Clay Wolf Show.
And they're working on the phones. We'll see if we get the phone system up. I feel sorry for David Koresh. I understand it now.
What?
It's just hard to get stuff done right out here.
In the country?
Yeah. I mean, we're out here. We're about 100 miles from Mount Carmel, but we're out here in central Texas in an undisclosed compound.
Compound.
Yeah. The Wolf Davidians.
Yeah, I like it. I like it. It's like you're the new Elvis.
The new Elvis? What's that?
He had a compound. Oh. Right? And he had a bunch of people around him.
Graceland.
Yeah.
And they did drugs, but we really just drink. And then he rode go-karts, and we ride four-wheelers. I got hurt. See? Elvis went down the other day.
Oh, yeah. How you doing, by the way? How's your shoulder?
My shoulder? It's good.
It's better now, right?
I got my stitches out.
All right.
And the doc said it's healing wonderfully. He'd never seen a 50-year-old guy heal up that quick. That's good. It's because I'm married to a 35-year-old woman.
That's good.
It helps. Mm. Or 37, 38, whatever she is these days. But did you know Lionel Messi went to Miami? He left Argentina. He's going to Miami for the soccer team.
Oh, yeah.
That's a big deal.
Yeah.
That's way bigger than Tom Brady on a worldwide stage.
With all kinds of concessions.
Oh.
They're going to give him his own team?
Yeah. He's getting a lot.
Are they really?
Yeah. It's like, you know what?
Like he's getting his own team? What's that mean?
Yeah, like he's got stake in a MLS team, soccer team.
MLS? I thought that was muscular dystrophy.
It's MDA.
Oh, no, it's okay.
The contract they give to me was fabulous.
I mean, and he's getting stake in the television. I mean, there's a lot of stuff they're giving him for.
A lot of concessions.
Yeah.
Do you think that soccer will ever get mainstream in the States?
No. It's not happening. Sorry.
They've been trying since Pele.
Yeah, just not
say it, Turley.
No.
Professional soccer's just a bit.
It's not a bit. No, no, no.
No, everything's
no.
a bit with you. It's
no,
a bit.
That's no,
a bit.
No.
Soccer's a bit.
We've got a lot of folks that give me the VIN office that are really big soccer fans.
Are they Hispanic?
Brits.
The British Bulldogs.
Oh.
Corday and Dan.
Oh, they
yeah.
love it?
Oh, yeah.
What's the Chelsea's, is that their team in England?
I can't remember. It's either Man U or Chelsea, one of them. One of them was upset about something.
All I know is I've never had, like, dirtier looks given to me than when I walk out there and see the soccer match and say, Liverpool, Liverpool. And they're all like, you bastard.
Did you see where the Mexico something game got shut down in Vegas because the Mexican fans were chanting gay slurs at the goalie on the other team?
Oh, they shut the game
down?
For trash talking?
And they charged them 100,000 Swiss francs?
Yeah.
I don't get, I mean, how confusing is that? Who was Mexico playing? I forgot. Anyway, they were like playing Canada. Mexico's playing Canada in Vegas. They're calling them the goalie homo in unison, as the entire crowd is.
In Spanish, right?
In Spanish. Yeah. And they fine them in Swiss dollars.
Fine who? The team?
Mexico's team.
Yeah, they're just the whole team.
The whole team. And they canceled the game because they've done this a lot. Those zany Mexicans just cannot quit calling goalies gay. If I'm lying, I'm dying.
Swiss francs? That's just an insult to injury.
The Swiss own the league?
I don't
probably,
know.
Probably. That's just their mode of currency.
And you're wondering why this will not make it in the States, okay?
Right, right.
Can you imagine at an NFL game, if you're trash talking...
It's not Swiss francs. Is it Swiss francs?
Yeah.
Isn't it Swiss marks?
Yeah, I think that's right. I want to make sure I didn't go down as a complete dumbass. I wanted to clean
just
that up.
Just halfway.
Who was the quarterback for the Arizona Cardinals for a long time, though? Jake the Snake?
Yeah, Jake Plummer.
Yeah, we called him that for years.
What, gay?
Yeah.
But don't do it now.
Just out
I'm
of fun.
They'll fine you in Swiss marks.
Just out of fun.
And stop the game.
They canceled the game. They didn't just stop it. They sent everybody home.
It was just a bit.
Now you
just
go.
Just a bit.
Yeah.
You're right, by the way. It's Franks.
Is it Swiss Franks?
Swiss Franks, okay. Yeah.
Okay.
And soccer's going to make it in the States. Come on. Never.
It's time... Since our phones don't work, we can only communicate by the written word from prisoners around the U.S. that write in to the JCW show. If you go to jcwshow.com and click contact us, our P.O. box number's right there, and you can send us mail from jail. And if we like it, we'll have Johnny Cash come over and read it. Johnny Cash, you here?
Hello, I'm Johnny Cash. John, I'm sorry to hear about your telephone. I had that once. I shared an apartment off Music Row with Willie.
Yeah?
For a long time, back in 1967, 68. And Willie had a girlfriend named Cocaine Katie. And she was constantly on the damn telephone. I couldn't get a call in and call out. It's horrible. I feel for you. Keep on going, Bart.
Thanks, Johnny.
This week's mail from jail letter reads, "Hey, John Clay, I love your radio show. Oh my gosh. It makes my morning every Saturday when I hear you and the crew's lovely voices. My name is Allison, but my friends here call me Alley Cat. Unfortunately, I was hooked pretty bad on meth, thanks to my stupid boyfriend, Tio.
Oh, a chick.
And I ended up in here for a methy hoe. I really do miss my family and my children. And if they hear this, Carly and Blade, I miss y'all so much. Ugh, I don't want to cry. I wish I could see y'all. JD sounds like
But all of my tear ducts are evaporated and dry because I've been up for a week straight on meth.
I would assume they don't allow them to have any meth in the joint, John. The letter continues. J.D. Ryan sounds like a dreamboat. Oh boy. I figured I'd share some jail secrets with you guys. The main thing you need to know is jail is boring. You literally sit around all day. I miss going to CC's Pizza so much. The food sucks, of course. Being a lady in jail's tough, too. The government-issued pads you get suck.
Suck.
And they don't work. So you have to get creative. I'll spare you the details. You have to make makeup out of whatever you can, too. I made a beautiful eyeshadow out of green Skittles. But it's sticky, so I don't wear it a lot. Jail does make you creative, though, and honestly, I feel like it's made me a better person. I want out, but I'm happy for the people I met in here. So please let me give a shout-out to Amanda, TT, and Consuela for being a light in the dark. And thank you, John Clay, for turning frowns into smiles every weekend. Love, your girl.
G.G. Drummond.
Alley Cat Carter.
Alley Cat Carter?
Alley Cat Carter.
Alley Cat Carter.
I believe that mail was from a woman.
She's going to come looking for you.
Well, she's a little incarcerated right now. I'm not that worried.
She'll get out.
Women in jail, do they?
Oh, yes.
Thank you, Johnny Cat.
Boy, things have gotten bad down there.
Speaking of crazy things in Vegas, that Mexican soccer story a moment ago. So the Oakland A's are moving to Vegas. They're following their Oakland Raiders, which makes sense. What are they going to name them?
Are they going to be the Las Vegas A's?
Yeah, they'll still be the A's.
The A-holes.
Yeah, they'll still be the Athletics.
You sure?
Yeah.
You don't think it's just a bit?
But it won't be Oakland anymore?
They won't. Goddamn, Gigi.
Huh? Oh boy.
How the hell would they be Oakland if they're in Las Vegas?
Well, I mean, but that's what they've always been, so they should just stick with the Oakland A's.
Change your wig. Get that blonde one off and put that black one back on.
You know what I mean? I did. I put my special show wig on.
Now, she saw it on the San Diego Chargers game.
Oh, they moved too, huh?
Oh, hell. Hey, Gigi, yeah, when Oakland moves to Vegas, I don't know if they're going to change the name from the A's, but I'm guarantee to you they're going to change the name from Oakland.
Oh, they shouldn't do that. They should leave it the same.
The Oakland Vegas A's?
Well, I mean, just take Vegas out of it. They don't even need to have Vegas in it.
Call
just
in. We need
A's.
To test these phones anyway. Tell me what they should change their names to.
Yeah, like the Oakland Raiders.
Well, they shouldn't be the Raiders.
They're the Vegas Raiders now.
Las Vegas.
That's right. So stupid.
The
that
High Rollers, the Athletics, the Gamblers, the Dealers, the Bandits.
Just the A's. If you can't have Oakland, then no Vegas, just the A's.
The Rat Pack, the
Oilers,
Strip.
Rams, Cardinals.
Can't be the Devils because they made the Devil monikers go away in the MLB. The Prostitutes? The Oakland Prostitutes?
Yeah, I don't know if that'll work.
not Oakland. The Vegas Prostitutes, the Vegas Wise Guys, the LA Mob, the Vegas Mob, Stardust. How about Flamingo? Grab an old casino. the Vegas Flamingos.
Golden Nuggets.
We'll ponder on that for a moment. Be right back in a minute. This show is proudly brought to you by GiveMeTheVIN.com, America's best car buyer. If GiveMeTheVIN does not beat a CarMax offer, it will send you a check for $100. Be right back.
The John Clay Wolf Show. JCWShow.com. The number one weekend morning show in America. John Clay Wolf.
Tastes good.
Hey, want more John Clay Wolf? Go to jcwshow.com for the fastest growing podcast in the U.S.
I'm not coming on. Randy, can you hear me? Randy, can you hear me? Randy, can you hear me?
Okay.
Yes, no?
Yeah, five of them. They all growed up.
Hey, Randy, can you hear me? Colin. You call him, please. Oh, you're on hold. Oh, I don't see you. What's your phone number? Does it end in 2207?
Yeah.
Okay. Turley, can you hear me? Go in the closet or something. Nothing?
On hold, I can hear you perfect.
Let me switch this over. I know this isn't going to change it, but does that do anything? Can you hear me now?
Okay.
And Bobo, we talk into your mic and see if he can hear you.
I'll tell you what.
It's so faint, but I can barely hear him.
See, I can hear you great. I hear you perfect.
It's light. I can hear you, but it's light.
So I'd have to yell at you, and it's not going to sound good.
Yeah, and that won't sound good. JD's
what about your other microphone?
Gotta have more gear. Hey, JD, I really hate that light.
Hey, John, what about your other microphone? Did you try your other microphone?
It's gonna sound just the same because your mic doesn't sound that great either. It's light.
My mic doesn't sound great. Yeah, there's
no. I can barely hear. Yeah.
Check. Can you hear me any better, Turley, on the phone?
No. Right. Try now. John.
Hello. Mike Turley.
It's light. It's a little better, but
that's
light.
How it was that's when we was first started.
Can't we turn it up?
Week one.
In the Telos?
No, it's already turned all the way up.
Huh. What if there's buttons pushed? It was not on this board because it's everybody.
His would be louder, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, here we go. Now we're going to take the whole show off the air.
Uh-oh.
Let me pull up the hood. My uncle's got a bitchin' set of tools. He can
fix
it.
While the car's running, let's pull the hood up.
How much time we got?
Talk.
Hi. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.
150. I mean, it's light. Yeah. So I'm going to have to make sure no music or anything in the background.
Okay. And hang on. Run in there and talk to pre-K and tell him he's going to have to coach these people that they're going to barely be able to hear me. And they're just going to have to talk.
to the John Clay Wolf Show, taking over your radio every Saturday morning.
Was she a lesbian?
She's
singing like a lesbian, but maybe not.
How do you seem like a lesbian?
I mean, the song that she's singing, it sounds kind of lesbian-like. She didn't change the pronouns. You know, we felt like we were seeing something a little nasty in the eighth grade when it came out.
I'm not talking if the song's lesbian. I'm asking if Joan Jett's lesbian. Crimson and Clover is not lesbian.
Yes, it is. It's a girl singing about a girl.
Is it?
Well, yes, she says, I don't hardly know her, but I think I could love her.
Okay.
When Tommy James sang that in 1965, he was singing that I don't really know her.
Right.
What's classy is that Joan Jett didn't feel a need to change the pronouns because it still fit for her just fine.
Yeah, how about that? Like that person on the basketball team when I played in undergraduate school.
What happened there?
She, you know what? I was greedy. I was young. I was stupid. She's like, hey, want to go smoke? I'm like, okay. And I'm thinking I'm doing big things because I get to smoke it all, right? She puts on the song Fire and Desire, and I'm not paying attention. I'm just happy to get high. And then she's like, well, I'm going to sing this song, and when I say I'm not changing anything about it, right? And she didn't change any of the pronouns, and she's looking at me like a big old snack. So, yeah.
Because she loves the ladies, man.
Yeah, she wanted to love this lady, but it didn't work out.
Did she lay one on you? Did she make the move?
She tried to, but my roommate saved me. I was so grateful. Yeah.
Sounds like your roommate ruined everything for me.
This is the song.
What is this called?
Fire and Desire.
Fire and Desire. That's Rick James and Tina Marie, baby.
Yeah, that's
so
it.
Was she a skinny gal or a big old wide stance gal?
No, she was, I mean, am I going to get in trouble if I say she was dykeified?
I mean, give them your phone numbers, they can call you, not me.
Yeah. She didn't want to take no for an answer. It was really weird.
How did that go? Tell me more.
She didn't want to take no for an answer. I mean, she would...
How did your roommate save you? Was your roommate right there, calling the shots? Ball, strike, foul!
No, because, see, what had happened was... And when listen, when my people tell a story and they say what had happened was, you know it's about to get good, right? So what had happened was, my roommate heard that she was trying to get me inebriated so that she could take advantage of the situation.
Yo! Ice Cube, Gigi's over there getting lesbian-fied. We need some help.
No, but so when my roommate heard, right, and by the time I figured out what was going on, I was lit, like three sheets to the wind, sitting there like, oh, no, you know what I mean? My roommate came, and she saved the day. She's like, no, but that was after the basketball player and her roommate got into an argument over me. That's what clued me in, because I heard them saying, no, yeah, you knew I liked her. You knew I wanted to be with her and so on and so forth. And I'm like, oh, no. But my roommate came. She was like, come on, girl, let's go to the inn.
Gigi's so. Doing no strides for the WNBA right now.
Ooh, sorry. Sorry, Brittany Griner.
I want to hear this song. What's she singing about? She's singing it.
I was cold as ice, you know. Okay. I wasn't very nice.
So this 6'2" gal in a dim-lit room is singing this to you.
We were in her car. We were in her car, so like, where could I go?
You could open the door and get out. But did you kiss her a little bit?
Hell no. I don't get down like that. I showed her a picture of the guy I was dating. And then she would do things. If I was sitting on a bar stool, she'd come up behind me and rub her breast on my back. I got my own set.
But she was so nice, she was like... Gigi, I really like
you. Yeah, she would come up behind me and be like, hey, girl, how you doing?
Yeah.
And I'm just like, I'm not with that.
Are y'all friends on Facebook?
No.
I want to look her up.
No, we don't. But wait. Okay.
Babe, you have my undivided attention. Go ahead.
So I'm going to keep this PG. There was someone I worked with a long time ago.
Right.
There was a little bit of attraction, you know what I mean? Just a little bit, you know what I mean? The kind that's just kind of a little bit, it's there, but you don't know what to do with it. And you know what I found out?
No.
One of her kids.
Yeah.
Guess what their name is?
Gigi.
Yes.
Oh, wow.
Not even joking.
Oh, wow.
Okay. Yeah.
You just thinking about it.
The one that got away.
I mean, I don't know. If I was going to be that way, I would be that way for somebody like her.
She's you know cool. I named my baby after you, Gigi.
Okay, you know what I mean? So every once in a while I look like, how's little Gigi doing?
I've been with a lot of gals.
That's right.
I mean, you know I'm lesbian. But I named my kid Gigi because I liked you so much.
She did. I mean, she never told me that, but I mean, what are the odds?
You know I just want to kiss you and hug you and marry you.
Okay, what are the odds?
You want to play some basketball?
What are the odds?
You want to play a game of pig?
What is that?
You don't know what pig is?
No.
Oh, stop. You're a basketball player? You don't know what pig is? Is this just a Central American?
Most people play horse.
Yeah, most people play horse. What is pig?
It's a shorter game of horse. Right. Yeah, three shots instead of five. That's right.
Okay.
But you do know how to play horse?
Well, yeah, you just shoot the ball.
And the guy, okay, I just...
I know that.
I just can't believe that you didn't know what pig was.
No, I mean, I wasn't the best basketball player, but I still posted my throwback picture, number 55.
Danny, yes, are you there? Danny, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
All right. Tell me what's on your mind.
Well, the Oakland Athletics weren't always from Oakland. They went from Philly to Kansas City to Oakland.
Okay.
And, you know, they did that migration out west like, you know, the Dodgers and the Giants. But they weren't always. I just didn't even realize that somebody said that they were getting ready to move to Vegas. I'm like, okay, just make them the Aces.
I agree.
Because the Athletics, yeah.
Dylan, can you hear me? Dylan, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Go.
Yeah, I was wondering, what do you think TCU's going to do in the College World Series?
I think TCU is going to win, but they got beat by Oral Roberts.
Praise God.
We need to have a prayer.
Oh, where's Reverend at?
For the TCU Horned Frogs.
Reverend
to beat Reverend? Jesus. I mean, it's hard to beat God. They're playing God. And this is Texas Christian University versus Oral Roberts University in the College World Series. I mean, there's a lot of religion going on. There's a lot of praying. I mean, whose side is he on?
Why
is he
asking me to do it right now?
Reverend Charles.
Trying to enjoy my oatmeal and raisins.
So, not that it's that, you know, it's not an every household thing, but the College World Series is going on. And it is two very religious schools.
They're Texas still playing football.
Christian University. No, baseball.
Oh.
Versus Oral Roberts.
College baseball.
Right.
They still do that.
College World Series. So TCU actually made it to the national championship in football and in baseball. So they must have God on their side. But they're playing Oral Roberts. Now, was Oral Roberts one of Jesus' disciples?
Oral Roberts?
Yeah.
No, he wasn't even alive at the time, I don't think. That, you know, don't get me started about the Gospels. I studied it all my life. But, you know, Oral Roberts is from what we would call modern history, 1960s, 70s. But Oral Roberts died.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
He was an evangelist, right?
He was very good. I'll admit, at a time, I was jealous of him, and I found my heart full of covetousness because he had, you know, Oral Roberts University, and you see it on TV every Sunday morning.
Sure.
You know, rich preacher. But I think he was good. You know, he never got caught with the hookers like Jimmy Swaggart did.
Hookers.
And the Jim Baker and Tammy Faye Baker. She had so much makeup, she looked like a costumed giraffe from the circus. Lord, Lord. But that's unkind words. I should not say this. But I will pray for you, brother. Join with me in prayer, children. Dear God.
Mm-hmm.
If you find it in your heart and we show that we thankful on the front end here before we ask, please find John Clay Wolf a better sport to watch than college baseball. Because, Lord, you know, in... three strikes, in nine innings many times over is bad enough to watch professionals do. Now they do it in college. You know, and if you got children in high school and you go and watch their games because you love them so, and you got children in college, you watch them. But if you ain't got no children in college and you watching college baseball, you might have too much time on your hands. So God, please pray for TCU and John Clay Wolf and Earl Roberts too, because he was the only preacher that was ever worth a darn.
Thank you.
Amen. Amen. Praise Amen. God.
Amen. Praise Amen. Hey, Daniel in Virginia, can you hear me? The phone's a little screwed up.
Yes.
A 12 Challenger RT was 70. We offered 13 at Give Me the VIN. You want 15. Right? He can't hear me.
Hello?
Okay. We offered you 13,000 and you want 15,000 for your Challenger?
Yeah, that's correct. All right.
Split the difference. We'll do 13,500. Yeah. That's an oddball split, my way.
Yeah, I got a little higher than that from a local dealer, so I was hoping it's clear title, no accidents.
I'll split the difference with you, 14 grand.
14?
Yeah, do that. Randy, what you got? Randy!
Yeah.
What you got?
You got an 04 Corvette, convertible, 6-speed, got 79,000 miles, and it's clean.
I've got a listener that's got a comment about your car and your convertible.
I don't care if you like a hard top or a soft top. I want to hear some hard rock.
All right.
You going to get it?
I'll give. How much is it?
I'm not going to get 20.
Oh, you're stoned.
I mean, it's clean. This clean thing ain't ever even been outside.
Yeah, I'll give 15. 15.
It's never been outside?
Never been outside. Car's never been outside, and Randy told you so. Oh. I mean, if you can't believe Randy, who the hell can you believe?
Right. If you're going to own a convertible, make sure you keep it indoors, whatever you do.
Randy, load it up into GimmeTheVin.com. We want to buy it. Let's take a look. Let's see how nice a car is that's never been outside. I'm excited about this one. I can't wait to announce that. This car has never been outside. But yeah, Randy, load it into the website, GiveMeTheVin.com. We are stretching to buy classic cars right now, and I want to try to buy that one, even though it's really not a classic. It's just kind of in a middle. It's kind of like in a middle zone where nobody really cares. It will be a classic in 10 years, but with the time value of money and interest rates, I'm really not interested in holding it in 10 years. Did you see where the Fed just met, and they did not raise rates again? Thank Lord, 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 hallelujah.
Amen.
All right, be right back. JCWshow.com is where you can get the video stream and the podcast this morning. GimmeTheVin.com is the website for one of our sponsors, and Gordon Boswell Flowers. The Fat Shot is almost back on. I think she's getting the stock back up with that Ozempic stuff. So I'll pitch that as soon as she tells me we're ready to go. Be right back.
The John Clay Wolf Show is heard every week on great stations like Oklahoma City's Rock 100.5 KATT, the legendary Cat Rocks, and Wilmington's 94.5 The Hawk, the Port City's classic hits. Stream us live online or pick up the country's fastest growing podcast at jcwshow.com and at johnclaywolf.com. And we'll be back with more of the John Clay Wolf Show right after this.
Appears to be an awful. Appears to be an awful time. Such a long, long time before the dawn. Speak up. You got to speak up against the madness.
house and she don't know. He's got her best friend on the phone. She'll wash her hair, his dirty clothes are all he gives to her. And he's got posters on the wall of all the girls he wished she was. And he means everything to her. Her boyfriend, he don't know anything about her. He's too stoned. Nintendo, I wish that I could make her see. Just the flavor of the week. It's Friday night and she's all alone. He's a million miles away. She's dressed to kill, but the TV's on. He's connected to the sound. And he's got pictures on the wall of all the girls he's loved before. Favorite songs. Her boyfriend, he don't know anything about her. He's too stoned. Nintendo, I wish that I could make her see. She's just the flavor of the week.
I'm talking through the microphone. What's up? Keep talking. All right. Lewis, stay on hold. Make sure you turn your radio off and your Bluetooth is disconnected. Just listen through your phone. All right. Thanks.
Her boyfriend, he don't know anything about her.
Have the time to listen to me whine about nothing and everything all at once. I am one of those melodramatic fools, neurotic to the bone, no doubt about it. Sometimes I give myself the creeps. Sometimes my mind plays tricks on me. It all keeps adding up. I think I'm cracking up. And am I just paranoid? Am I just up? I went to a shrink.
Hey, Gigi.
Yes.
All right, we're going to test to see if your side works better for phones.
Okay. What do you want me to do?
You're just going to talk to me. Hold on. There's a phone.
Hey, Gigi, can you hear me?
I can hear you just fine. I hear an echo, too.
Go ahead, keep talking.
Well, let me see. I can talk about a lot of things, like the way that emergency crews responded to a swarm of bees in Los Angeles. And when a volunteer got to the scene, he was overwhelmed and collapsed on camera.
Yeah, she's better. So she is better. Okay. All right, thanks.
Eventually, you want me to stop talking?
One minute.
Sometimes I give myself the creeps. Sometimes
Broadcasting live from the Wolf Radio Studios, it's time for the John Clay Wolf Show. From coast to coast, the largest weekend morning show heard all across America.
Recorded and subject to monitoring at any time. Dallas, Nashville. To accept this call, press 5.
Broadcasting live from the Wolf Radio Studios, it's time for the John Clay Wolf Show. From coast to coast, the largest weekend morning show heard all across America. Los Angeles, Phoenix, Houston, Dallas, Nashville, San Diego, Las Vegas, Denver, New Orleans, Oklahoma City, Austin, and available to the rest of the world at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolf.com. This is the John Clay Wolf Show.
All right, the phones are screwed up today. Imagine that. Brand new studio, spend a gazillion dollars and nothing works. But we're going to try this again. Tiger King, Joe Exotic is on line 3. Joe, can you hear me?
Good morning.
Hey, can you hear me okay?
I can barely hear you.
Okay, that's just the way it's going to work today. How the hell are you? Where have you been? What's going on? How's the presidential run?
Can't hear you at all now.
Okay, well then you just talk. They can hear you. So this is open mic night for Joe Exotic.
Hey, y'all need to work for the BOP and the Department of Justice. They can't get none of their stuff to work either.
Gigi can talk to him.
Gigi, you talk to him.
Oh, so since I get to talk to him, how about...
I can hear Gigi.
You can Gigi's hear me. So what about together. The dating show for me? Have you found me a person yet?
I'm ready to put you on the website whenever you're ready, darling.
I'm ready. I am so ready.
I will hook you up.
So when you get elected president, is there a place for me in your cabinet?
I'll be sure that it's not with the woman who wants to make out with you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. So is there a place for me in your presidential cabinet?
You bet. You bet. You'd be my press secretary.
Ooh, okay, I like that. I'm digging it. I'm feeling it. So how you been?
Not too bad. You know, the first week they had a fake medical call out, so I missed that show. And then the week after that, they shut the phones off. Then the week after that, I ran out of phone minutes. So, hell, I thought there for a minute I was going to be fired.
No, you can't get fired. You took a picture with Shaq. I saw a picture of you and Shaq. Did you really get to meet him?
Yeah, Shaq come to the zoo quite often and hung out.
Are you for real?
I am for real.
Oh, my
gosh. And you know what's funny? As big as that man is, he's scared of everything.
Really? Did the tigers not like him?
Are you there?
Are you still there?
Did the tigers not like him?
Did the tigers not like him? Can you hear me?
He didn't like chickens or ducks or nothing. He's scared of, everything.
Oh, I saw that picture, and I'm like, oh, my goodness, he met him for real.
Oh, yeah.
Super excited about that.
We're talking to Joe Exotic.
In the years of doing the zoo and traveling around doing magic, I met people like Alan Jackson and Reba McEntire and Trick Pony and all of them, yeah.
Oh, that's so cool. So what's the most interesting person that you met?
Let's see, the most interesting person I met.
Mm-hmm.
J.D. Ryan.
That we probably have to, the coolest person that I ever met, honestly, was Randy Travis.
Okay, and, so tell me about it.
And the biggest moron I ever met was Dwight Yoakam.
What made him a moron?
He's just...
This call is from a federal prison.
You want to talk about somebody that has no personality and he is so stuck on himself is Dwight Yoakam.
Oh, no. How'd you meet him?
I did a show that he was doing a show at the same time in Davenport, Iowa at the Tri-County Fair.
Mm-hmm.
And got to meet him there backstage. And, I was pretty disappointed.
Okay. Okay, so you were at the fair. I'm going to the fair. What's your favorite fair food?
My favorite fair food. Got to be the funnel cakes.
Okay. How do you like your funnel cakes?
Funnel cakes and corn dogs.
Funnel cakes and corn dogs. Do you get the whipped cream and the strawberries on the funnel cake, or you eat it plain?
Just plain. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. That's good.
Gigi is talking shop with Joe Exotic, the Tiger King.
What do you think about my buddy Trump?
Oh my! I'm so like people. They get their panties in a snit, right? And they're just like, oh, they got him now. They got him now. He's not going to prison. He's not going to jail. Do you get that?
Some bitch.
Hey, let me tell you though. Being that I've been through this system and I've been through a federal court, you know why they don't allow cameras in the federal courtroom so that you can't document the corruption? They have something, whether, I mean, you got to understand that the federal court system convicts you on hearsay, where a state court can't. So all they need is two people to verify a story, and they've got him. Trust me, out of 37 counts, they're going to convict him of something.
Now,
whether
he
spends a day in jail or not, that's another thing. But, you know, if I was a politician in today's world, I'd be rethinking my border policy and bashing too many Hispanic people, because when you land up in here, you're going to be outnumbered, buddy. They're going to be your best friends.
Oh, so he better change his talk, huh?
He better change his talk.
He better change, or else he's coming to be your cellie, huh?
But
I mean,
sad.
You're in federal prison, too.
Our country has come to this. Huh?
Right?
Cool.
Pardon me?
No, she was just saying that you're in federal prison too. Joe, thank you for calling in today. We got to jump onto the next deal. We'll talk to you next week. We'll have our phones fixed. All right. Yeah, gee, it's just too screwed up. The phones are jacked.
I was having a good time.
Listen to Gigi interviewing though. She did a great job. That's your first
thank
time.
You, thank you, Bobo.
Funnel cakes and all, baby.
Funnel cakes and all.
Your first celebrity interview.
Thank you. And he met Shaq.
And hates Dwight Yoakam.
Right.
Which is
weird. Talked to him about Prince Albert's and yeah, it's just, and she talks to him about funnel cakes.
And two different viewpoints.
And sausages.
She did good. It's hard to talk to famous people, man. It's like you know, you get pent up. Gigi, you did a great job. Great job.
Thank you, Bobo. Thank you so much.
Lewis, good morning. You're on the air.
God dang.
Lewis, are you there?
Yeah, right here, Joe.
Yeah, I can barely hear you, but yes.
What you got?
I can barely hear you.
I know it's broken, but what you're on
he
the
He said,
air.
What you got?
Oh, you guys can hear me now? Okay. Hey.
Hey.
Wanted to ask you guys. I'm a new listener. I actually started listening to you guys today. Who are you guys? I'm from Houston. I'm a truck driver. I drive Monday through Friday. I recently started driving on Saturdays. But Monday through Friday is our typical, you know, in the morning, Rod Ryan show. Then after him, it's Jeremy. Then Teresa. You know, I know the schedule, but right. On Saturdays and Sundays, you know, I didn't know you guys existed. So who are you guys? Are you guys based out of Houston? What do you guys talk about? You know, well, want to know more about you guys.
You know what we're talking about if you've been listening to us. We just talk about nothing. But we're entertainment-based.
Give me a sec.
I've been doing this. Here, I got to cut you loose. I can just answer that phones aren't working right. We talk about the biggest son of a bitches is what we talk about. And this week's biggest son of a bitch is right now.
When his lawyer asks why he's seeking a divorce, he complains that the wife is out all night, every night, going from bar to bar. The lawyer asks, is she an alcoholic, or do you think she's cheating on you? His answer is no, but I'm sick and tired of her constantly following me around. His ancient old work truck has seen better days, but he's sure it's faster than his father-in-law's brand new Corvette, especially now that he's slashed the bastard's tires. He describes his most recent breakup a matter of pure harassment. She was never his favorite, but harassment a lot to him. He is the world's biggest son of a bitch.
Hey man, I don't always drink beer, but when I do, make mine a natty like tall boy. Yeah, buddy!
What did that guy want to know? Who are we?
Yeah.
Who are we?
Who are we? Who are you? Mm-hmm. Who, who? Oh, I really want to know. I don't know who I am.
A big old tallywhacker.
All right. I'm a truck driver. That guy really knew the local programming on his station.
Oh, yeah.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
You know, at 9:10, Les Nesbitt comes on with the news. Turkeys can fly. All right. Good morning, Los Angeles. Good morning, San Diego. It's time for the car segment coming up. 800-800-7234. 800 800 radio during this commercial interlude. Load up the phones, 800-800-RADIO. This is Dwight Yoakam. This is who Joe Exotic hates.
Yes.
Because he's just so full of himself. Isn't that just the easy way out? He's just so full of himself. That's like JD. You know how full of himself JD is.
What?
Where did that come from?
He's the worst.
I am.
All right. 800-800-7234. 800-800-RADIO. When we get back, I do want to talk about who we are. We'll go backwards a little bit. We've added a lot of new affiliates, too. And I want to know who that is. I've got a lot to say, actually. When we come back, well, actually, we've got to do the car segment, then we'll do it after that. I'm going to answer the guy's question deeper than he was even anticipating. My name is John Clay Wolf, Buy Cars on Radio for America's Best Car Buyer. Give me the VIN, give me the VIN, give me the VIN.com. If you'd like to sell your car right now, please go to givemethevin.com. You'll get an automated bid immediately, and a buyer will contact you via text and negotiate the deal. Send some pictures. It helps. It lets us know you're more serious. Because our conversion rate on buying cars that have pictures is much higher than people that don't even take the time to take pictures. That means they really don't give a damn. And if they really don't give a damn, then we don't give a damn either. At givemethevin.com. We'll be right back.
Not look like it.
Listening.
But we are actually kind of hip.
To the John Clay Wolf Show.
Why does it have to be so loud?
And check out the podcast at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolf.com.
1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1-2-1. Okay. Stay on hold. Am I on right now? Dan, can you hear me? Dan, stay on hold. We're going to go through this car segment, but just stay hooked for a minute. And in about 8 minutes, we'll get to you.
Now, back to the John Clay Wolf Show. Hit him up right now. Now, back to the John Clay Wolf Show. Hit him up right now. 1-800-800-RADIO. This is the John Clay Wolf Show.
And this is where we do the car segment real quick. We bid cars right here on the air for GiveMeTheVIN.com. That's where the bids are good. Let's see. Joe, you have a 19 F-150 SXT. Is it the... It says six-cylinder. Is it the turbocharged or the non-turbocharged?
It's an EcoBoost.
Okay, so it's a twin-turbo Eco. That's a 3.3, right? The displacement?
I think so, yes.
Okay, I'm not sure. What is it? Is it STX? So it's a... These damn trucks have so many variables. Yes. And it's an extended cab or crew cab?
Crew cab.
How many miles?
34,000
miles. I think the miles and the money are about the same. I think it's $33,000 truck. It's STX. $30,000 truck.
$30,000?
Yep. Okay. $30,000. Go to GiveMeTheVIN.com, load her up. All right. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Uh-huh. Randy, you have a truck, a 19 Silverado Chevy half-ton Trail Boss Z51. For those that don't know, what is the Trail Boss package consist of?
It's a factory lift, four-wheel drive, okay. Big tires, big wheels.
Leather or cloth?
It's cloth, got door-to-door, like the WeatherTech, 100% coverage, floor mats, front and rear.
Is it extended cab or crew cab?
It's extended cab. I think it's the smaller doors. It's not the big door like the crew.
Okay. So it's a double cab. Trail Boss.
Double cab. Okay.
Double cab.
That's what I was looking for.
How many miles?
Yeah, spray and bed liner. It's got just about 40.
I'm a 32, $33,000 buyer.
That might do it.
Holla, holla. Go to GiveMeTheVIN.com. 800-800-7234. Remember, you can go to JCWShow.com. Click the video link. We don't charge for it like a lot of these shows do. You can just go right to it, and you can see the audio and video of us in the studio if you want to watch it on television that way or whatever television is these days. I'm confused what a TV is. Anyway, we'll get all that in a minute. My name's John Clay Wolf. Be right back.
The John Clay Wolf Show.
No one knew where he came from.
But everybody wanted what he was selling.
Check out the podcast.
He was just some hillbilly who got on a plane and then just landed somewhere.
Please beware. The voice in your head is a threat.
JCWShow.com or JohnClayWolf.com.
Hey, 1-2. Early summer excessive heat. Orlando, Tampa, Sebastian, Cape Coral, Jupiter, Naples, Miami. Okay, you mean bring me down a little bit right here? I'm bringing me down a little bit here. Does that help when I bring me down a little bit here? Key West, Florida. Heat advisories for southern tip of Florida Peninsula. Is that where you want me?
Yeah.
Okay.
You're not pushing yourself too hard?
Mm-mm. And I'm sure I could hear it in the headphones. Well, I can put my headphones on. Hold on. Oh, okay. Now you can you buy my? Yeah, well, it's still overmodded a little bit, Sean. Can you buy my dad's classic truck, an 85 Chevy Stepside. Do you want me to leave mine set where it was here, or do you mean bring it down? Bring it down a little bit? Okay. Let me read something. Love, we didn't want to swap the module. We just wanted to turn it down, didn't we? Yeah. Love the show. I listened for the liberal theme. Huh. That's interesting. It still, it, yeah, it doesn't sound quite as good as it did, does it? Now we got to retune the whole, heads up, listening on the computer and hearing you off-air comments. Heads up, we understand. That's why streaming listeners get to hear the bad bull. One, two, three, four. Good vibrations. Oh, I sound right? Okay. Big old tallywhacker.
John Clay Wolf Show. Heard every Saturday morning across America. Los Angeles, Phoenix, Houston, Dallas, Nashville, San Diego, Las Vegas, Denver, New Orleans, Oklahoma City, Austin, and available to the rest of the world at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolf.com. This is the John Clay Wolf Show.
You know, instead of me explaining who we are, why don't you guys call and explain to this guy who we are? 800-800-7234, 800-800-RADIO. It's weird. I've had three people on the board this morning, like, new listener, who are you, what are you? I like it. Okay.
We've got some new stations out there.
How many new stations do we have?
I can count four in the last 2-3 weeks. You know, the new ones this week in Columbus.
Columbus what? Ohio?
Georgia.
Georgia. I was in Georgia last week.
WVRK, Rock 103 Columbus Rock Station. And in Macon.
Georgia.
Glad to be on in Macon. WQBZ. Say that like Howard Stern's program director.
WQBZ.
Q1063.
No, QBZ.
Q1063 Middle Georgia's Rock Station. They're new. Also in kind of close to Fort Myers, really, literally, they're in Punta Gorda.
Punta, isn't that a bad word in Spanish?
Yeah, on the prettiest coastal town in the state of Florida, in my opinion, from pictures I've seen.
Punta Gorda.
Yeah, on Charlotte Harbor. Charlotte Harbor's classic rock, big, 98.9. And in Fayetteville.
Fayetteville what?
North Carolina, WRCQ, Rock 103, Carolina's rock station.
Dude, we're on a lot of stations in the South, in Florida and in North Carolina. We added a lot in North Carolina.
Carolina has really come on, man.
And Florida has, too.
Yeah.
And L.A., we're on KLOS. Anyway, who are we? What are we?
We don't know.
I don't know, man. This has been such a weird deal. This whole thing has been such a weird deal. To think I'm sitting here on this microphone talking around the country... Dude, it was such a pain in the ass to get here. I don't even know if it's worth it.
I'm telling you.
What?
I mean, it was such a pain in the ass, JD.
I was watching it. I know.
Yeah, you weren't doing it. I was doing it. I was doing it.
Yeah.
All these pricks in the radio business.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God almighty. You know, so they... Yeah, how did we get here? Okay, 17 years ago, I start on this BFE station that I still love.
Wichita Falls, Texas. Good morning. I love you. With a little dream. Little cripple boy. You know, you're the little black girl, Gigi.
That's right. I'm the little
black
girl.
And I was a little cripple boy. So I
you
had
be sea walking, huh?
I had a bad motocross accident, and I'm all crippled up, and I'm in a wheelchair. They're like, he's never going to walk again. You know, what about Johnny? Well, he's never going to walk again. I mean, some people are like, just put a bullet in him and put him on the side of the road. My in-laws. So I'm like, what the hell am I, can I do from a wheelchair? And I'm like, radio. I always loved radio. When I was a little kid, I was sitting there with my room, and I had my turntable set up and a cassette player and doing the whole thing that a lot of people did. But radio was my gig. That's what I loved. And I was like, I can do that. And I used to be, I did some stand-up years ago in college. That's what I can do from a wheelchair. They won't know I'm in a wheelchair. So I talk them into letting me do 9 to 10 on Saturday morning on 94.5 The Outlaw in Wichita Falls, Texas. I mean, I was from Dallas. I was living out there because I had a fort. Anyway, long story. So we do this thing, and they pair me with one of their jocks because they're scared to let me do it alone. And it took about 6 months to get rid of Scotty, the guy that was with me. Love Scotty. He's fine, but he was your typical smiley, good morning country music DJ, yeah.
Scotty Preston.
Scotty Preston. I'm smiling. You feel my smile through the radio, right? Because I am smiling.
Did you know he passed away last year?
God rest in peace, Scotty Preston.
I didn't know if you knew. Yeah, it hit me all of a sudden. Like just a few weeks ago, my daughter is his daughter's best friend. She said, you know, Scotty died. I was like, oh,
Scotty's no. Scotty's not dead.
Yeah, he did.
Shut up.
He really did.
I'm going to call him right now.
Oh, God.
Hello? How did you get rid of him? Because you must have done something to irritate him. Or...
Oh, no, John.
I moved the studio to my own studio because I knew he wouldn't want to drive.
There you go.
The same thing I did with y'all. I moved the studio out here and all y'all came. I didn't think y'all would keep coming.
It didn't work, did it?
Ain't shaking
Scotty
his
didn't
head.
Die. What the hell's wrong with my phone? Why is it not working?
He really did. Because
you're in the country.
Yeah, because you're 90 miles out of town.
Okay, so this dude's dead, so I killed him. He's not dead.
He really did.
Somebody up there in Wichita Falls, call in 800-800-7234. Scotty, if you're listening, from heaven or earth, please call in. I know you're alive. That's not true. You're lying, and I don't appreciate it.
Whatever, dude. Typical okay. Trumper.
And then, how much time do I have? Dude, this story's too long.
You got 5 minutes.
Yeah, I can't tell this story in 5 minutes. It takes like 3 hours. Cliff notes. Okay, so we do well in Wichita Falls, start doing this thing called the Daily Nooner. Rush Limbaugh is the lead at noon, obviously. I'm like, if we can beat him in the book, then I'm going to keep doing this. We beat him on a chicken-ass station. It took about 6 months, or matched him, basically, not beat him. I'm like, okay. So took the moved back home to Dallas, and I started the Saturday thing on 105.3 The Fan in Dallas, and 7 to 9 a.m., and it was the car show. JD was on a show with this prick that's dead.
God, everybody I've ever worked with is dead.
Right, everybody's dead or in jail that you work with.
In jail, prison, yeah.
And so he was the big deal in Dallas. He was the Howard Stern hot talker in Dallas. And JD was part of that show. They broke up. I think JD threatened to kill him or something.
I did.
And that's how I met JD. But, dude, literally, just to get that gig on The Fan, I had to sit there outside that stupid-ass radio studio because it had security around it and wait for a door open on the side, and I slid in. I'd been talking to the program director via email for about a year. His name's Gavin Spittle. Nice guy. He was friendly, but we never could. I never could get him on the phone. It was just email. So lots of email talk.
Lots.
And then so the door opened. I was sitting there in my car like a damn stalker, like Jeffrey Dahmer. And I slide in before the door closed. And I went in his office and sat down. Gavin, hey, what's up? Who are you? John Claywolf. Oh, wow.
How are you?
How are you? Scared the hell out of him. Scared the hell out of him.
How'd you get in here?
I'm like, hey, I want to do this deal we've been talking about. Well, guy was just freaking out. Like, are you armed? No, I'm not armed. I'm here. I'm trying to do something with you. I'm tired of talking on email. I mean, God, this isn't a chat room for, like, pedophiles. Let's be men and talk face-to-face. So we made a deal. And then, like, I start on that station, and 3 weeks in, Gavin gets the bullet. He gets fired.
Man. Yeah.
And this complete a-hole named Tom Bigby.
Awful man.
Took
also
over.
Dead, by the way.
He's dead, right. I killed him, too.
Yeah.
So this is really a story about murder.
the people in our past are dead.
Whatever it takes.
So the Russ Martin.
We all got a bullet. Yeah, I got a bullet.
Oh, yeah. Turley was working there at that station. He got fired. JD got fired. Russ Martin got fired. Then they moved to the Eagle, and I moved to the Eagle. And really what was going on is the iHeart was just jacking with the competitor, and they were just trying to just do anything. The lady that ran iHeart came up to me at the Christmas party all drunk, and she's like, when we brought you on, dude, we thought it would last like 3 weeks. We were just doing that to punk them. I didn't figure you'd be here 3 years later.
Successful.
So we're trying to add more affiliates. I want to grow this thing. Houston was the first one. But it was on ESPN. We've been on there for like 13 years. Yeah. But the fan feedback was strong, strong, strong. When we got a listener, it was sticky, sticky, sticky. They'd last. We go to California. I'm wanting to go to California. I'm like, we got to take down LA. No. No, no. I heard no so much. This is a decade-long story about murdering program directors and other air talents. I secretly killed them all. And no's. And then finally, it took like 12 years for the wall to finally come down. And now how many stations are we on? I don't even know. Dude, when we would add a station in the past, I'd be all excited about it. We'd be prepping for it during the week. Oh, my God. Oklahoma City's fixing to start. Yeah. You know, what are we going to do? We got to send out press releases. We got to do that, blah, 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 blah. And now we're adding a state. What, do we have 70? I don't even know.
66 this week as of this morning. Yeah. But we do.
We know what our cumulative audience is.
We still get excited. Kansas City, Pittsburgh. What? WDVE Pittsburgh. Right. Wow.
Miami's fixing to start.
Wow.
The L.A. thing is what I loved is because everybody said we were going to get kicked off the air in L.A. immediately. They're going to hate us.
Won't last.
No. And I met some good people out there. I met Peter Tilden out there. I met David Hall out there, big radio heads. And they started coaching on me and y'all, all of us as a group, and started working with us. And, dude, the people in California are cool as hell.
Good people.
I'm talking across the country right now, right? I'm a Texan. I know what you think about California. I thought the same. A bunch of crazy liberals that don't make any sense. They're so vain. They're so caught up in their self, they can't even think straight. All they want to do is pay taxes and bitch about gay rights. That is not California.
Yeah.
Are there parts of that? Sure, but there are parts of that. Austin, Texas. You ever been there? Same thing. California's super cool, dude. Yeah. But that was so fun to be welcomed in California, get ratings in California. It actually worked. See, I told you the story's too long. We're already out of time.
Every week we get new listeners, but also every week we lose listeners, and we'll read a story from one of our lost listeners coming up.
Oh,
look at that. Tease right there.
How about that?
I'll finish this when we get back. My name's John Clay Wolf. My car's rated for America's Best Car Buyer. GiveMeTheVIN.com.
You're listening to the most popular Saturday morning show to ever broadcast in America. You're listening to the John Clay Wolf Show. Feel free to call and make your voice heard. 800-800-RADIO. If you missed any of the show, go to jcwshow.com right now and download the podcast, The John Clay Wolf Show.
Pre-K, you're spinning today.
So many times it happens too fast. You change your passion for glory. Don't lose your grip.
Let me see if I can do it. I can do it. Cool. Hey, Crab, Daniel, Justin, stay hooked. I'm going to get back to this in a minute when we come back.
Return to the John Clay Wolf Show, America's largest weekend morning show, presented by GiveMeTheVin.com. Call in 800-800-RADIO, 800-800-RADIO, and check out the podcast at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolf.com. This is the John Clay Wolf Show.
We're chilling. It's Saturday. A couple of listeners, new listeners, called and wanted to know who we are and why they like us. That was kind of the question. We like it. We don't know what it is. Who are you? What are you? So I've been telling the backstory on how we got to your radio dial. I was talking about California a minute ago. This guy, hey, Crab, you there?
Hey, guys.
Who are we? Who are we?
John, but
who are we and what are we?
Highly entertaining. Like, the similarities between the Stern Show and yours are pretty there, but... I think Gigi adds her velvet voice every once in a while, and
you just
and
got Jungle Fever,
and Bobo.
Get it,
and,
get it.
I can't hear you, Don.
You can.
Yeah, he said you just got Jungle Fever.
That's funny.
The similarities between us and the Stern Show are bare. I didn't. Why did you bring it up? I don't understand what you're saying there.
Because that's what I thought when I first started listening years or two ago, and you know, Bobo's like Fred, you know, the impressions and stuff. And Reverend Charles, I love him. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it's just topical and entertainment, man. It's a Saturday morning's way to spend the day, the morning.
Thank you, Crab. All right. And while we're talking backtracks here, the guy from Houston, the program director that I hated and he hated me, you got to understand, when we join these stations, the program directors are pissed. Absolutely pissed.
By and large.
Absolutely. Yeah. Elliot, are you there?
Elliot!
Yeah, man.
I mean, were you pissed?
Hey, guys. Well, mostly because Baba would just do imitations of me on the air. So there was so we didn't start off on the best foot, right?
Hey, guys. It's y'all are doing a good show this morning. Tell you what happened out in Fayetteville, North Carolina. Y'all on out there? I hope you are, because you got 6 meters.
Woo! Meters are the judging thing from the rating system, and that's what PDs look at. Is how
good morning, E. Wood, my man.
Yeah. Right. That's how the sausage is made, and yeah, I'm sure nobody cares about that. But
right.
Bobo did a wonderful job of embellishing my greatness by boiling me down to a few nuts and bolts there.
So when we start these new stations, I've got to meet Elliot is the Buzz program director down in Houston, and right. He was in Pittsburgh for a long time. Hell, you worked at DVE, didn't you?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right, guys. Well, you're on now. You got crammed down from corporate. I've got to deal with you now. So it's my job to fix you every time. Now we really don't take those phone calls anymore. But when we first started with Houston, Elliot, it wasn't even you, it was Mark. But, you know, so when you got a hold of us, how are you going to fix us? I think we were better before y'all fixed us, by the way. Back when we were bigger jerks, I liked it better.
Well, you're a little too. I think you're a little too. You worked well in the margins, but again, like people just hearing things, you really would touch some hot points that would make people mad. So that's always when we're scaring away any listeners, I get nervous.
Okay, so you have no balls.
Oh.
Whoa! I want to win, John. John, I want to win.
I know it, but you win on the edge. You win on the spice. I mean, you got to have the sizzle. You got to push the buttons. I think. You know what I'm most disappointed about is we don't get enough complaints anymore.
We don't. In fact, we get barely any complaints at all. I think we've sanded down the edges. John, you're doing great. Good job.
It's terrible, Elliot.
Why? Why do you think
that?
It's not.
You need complaints. If they're not complaining, then you're not being polarizing, and you're not getting them so mad that they listen more than the people that love you. And, I mean, the complaints, dude, I'm not a Trumper, so I hate using this example. But the man ran that playbook, and he got elected president because of it. He had the eyeballs. He had the ears. It's the same thing. He says, I don't know. I just think if you're trying to serve everybody and be so happy and so milk toast, that there's just nothing there and you're just another show. And y'all ruined that for me. And I hate you for it.
Well, I agree with what you're saying, that there's got to be some edges. But I think that there's different places where the edges can go where people will like.
Right.
And I think that a lot of those places you were touching on were just the ones that kind of, got under people's skin.
Do you remember any of them? Can we go through some of them? Tell me about
some terrible ones. I hate to be the one repeating them on the air.
I just love to hear. I just want to hear about back when I was good. Can you tell me about some of the things that I did that you hated?
I think what was the accidental racist? You always would do, pick some group to hate, and maybe hate's too strong, but it would be to stereotype and to be a little strong that way.
Oh, the white.
I think that always.
And they made me kill that segment, black, white, Latino, or other. That was like, I almost got fired over that.
Yeah.
That was a great segment.
That was a great segment.
there's that. I think you do a good job at pulling stuff out where it's kind of those fringy elements. So if there is, and again, not to go down the Trump or the political side, but when you're touching on certain things like that, people just have their asses up on their shoulders these days. And if the mention of Hillary or the mention of Trump, totally, even if you're just saying it in a newscast, neutral, just saying, hey, here's what happened. People just don't tend to listen like they used to. They just immediately go, you just go nuclear, and they just don't want to hear it. So that's the trouble with being a, you know, a PD, is that, you know, again, I get calls from guys, like, you know, if our weekday morning guy says too many things about, if he mentions something about puppies, you know, we get the PETA people calling us, mm-hmm. and we're saying, no, we like puppies. Yeah, don't talk about them. And it's just, people are just very reactionary. Mm-hmm. And I think you push buttons, and that's what you did. And I think that a lot of the buttons you pushed were, you know, dangerous buttons.
Nuclear.
And you're mellowing, John. You're becoming more of a statesman.
You ruined me. We're on the phone with Elliot Wood, the program director on The Buzz in Houston, and we were talking about old times. And when we first, how long have I been on The Buzz? Like 6 years, 7 years, 6 years?
Yeah, something like that.
Right. You lost half your hair, right? So your morning show
I had jet black hair when you first came on, and now it's gray.
Your morning show still hates us.
Gray hair.
Your morning show still hates us.
Yeah, that's true. True. Mm-hmm. That's true.
Why do they hate us?
Yeah.
Why is that a factor? Everywhere I go, the morning show's hating us.
Well, because in our case, it's just usually we had 4 hours of best of and replay bits from his show, so you cut right into that. Oh. So that knocked out 3 hours of that.
But did that change his pay?
No, I'm sure it didn't.
Okay, so why does he give a rat's ass?
Well, it just, again, it comes down to the exposure. Like, the more you can, it takes away, you know, if they chop down half the billboards on the roads that you're driving past, it's less chances that you stay top of mind.
Well, does he want to start calling in every Saturday?
Part of that.
We have Joe Exotic on every Saturday. We could have Rod Ryan on every Saturday and call in.
Well, okay. I don't know. Maybe I don't think he would do it, but yeah, maybe.
A lot of these stations that we're on, I get on the morning shows with them. We're on Heidi and Frank all the time. I've been on with y'all for seven years, and you've never invited me down to sit in on the morning show with you. When Rod's on vacation, why don't you ever call me to have me come sit in and carry that week?
That's all right. You get on Saturday, John.
He said, that's all right.
It's all right. All right, Elliot. I appreciate it. Love you, man. I've enjoyed it.
Love you. Bobo, keep up the good work. John, not so much, but Bobo, you're doing the Lord's work.
I got you covered, buddy.
Lance, Houston.
Yes, sir. A few minutes ago, y'all were talking about, you know, the whole Saturday morning thing, and it just, y'all remind me of, like, Saturday morning cartoons as a kid, but, like, for adults.
All right.
We've said that for years.
Yeah, I think that's the gig. So, are you a Buzz listener?
I am, actually. That's how I heard about you guys.
Why do you think the morning show in Houston hates us so much?
I think y'all say and do what they aren't allowed to, if I had to take a shot.
I think your shot is dead on. Thank you. Daniel, good morning. You're on the air.
Yes, sir. Speaking about the show, I had an idea. If you guys are familiar with Shark Tank on TV, Netflix, of course, is doing series. That's pretty hot. But kind of watching movies. But as far as you guys, maybe you can guys make some content auctioning classic cars, hot rod cars.
I thought about
luxury
that.
Cars.
I think we need to do that. Do you have a camera and a bong?
I do.
All right, well, come on, let's do it. Don, good morning. You're on the air.
John?
Yes, sir.
I want to tell you something. I'll be 70 here pretty quick.
All right, young man.
And you know who my nephew is, of course. Mm-hmm. And an Uncle Don. What I'm trying to tell you. Right. But anyway, not your uncle, but somebody else's uncle that you went to school with. That's no big deal. I just want to tell you that you have done the most amazing job in the world. I don't think anybody can do anything. I've been through 4 surgeries this year myself. Well, actually, in the last 14 months. So I kind of know where you're coming from. But anyway, hey, you absolutely... keep it going. I think you've got a fantastic show.
Thanks, Don. Justin, are you telling me that guy we were talking about earlier, Scotty Preston, he's dead?
Scotty Preston's gone, man. Yeah, he died 7 months ago, maybe 8. You know, he's been sick. He had cancer
Rest
forever.
In peace, Scotty Preston. Mike, Houston.
Yeah, John, hey, long-time listener, man. You know...
here's the deal. I'm a 94.5 listener, okay, during the week.
Right.
And the good here's the good news, right? For y'all on 94.5 The Buzz, just keep your radio on the same damn station. You get the best programming on the site. And it was edgy. I liked it when it was edgy. That's what drew me into this whole thing, John.
They neutered me,
dude.
I don't
like being in the marshmallow.
Have you ever taken your dog to the veterinarian and they chopped his nuts off?
Yes, I did.
Yeah, that's what happened to me. I didn't get both chopped off, but I got one. I want to find it. Can I borrow one of yours? My name's John Clay Wolf. I'll be right back.
The John Clay Wolf Show's heard every week on great stations like San Diego's Classic Rock, 101.5 KGB, and Colleen Temple and Fort Hood's KLFX, 107.3 The Fox Rocks. Stream us live online or pick up the country's fastest growing podcast at jcwshow.com and at johnclaywolf.com. And we'll be back with more of The John Clay Wolf Show right after this.
To me.
25 seconds.
Good morning, everyone. We've been talking a little flashback today. For those of y'all who just missed or just tuned in, grab the podcast. It goes up this afternoon at jcwshow.com. And the video feed is also live right now at jcwshow.com. We've got cameras in here now, finally, after 17 years. One thing we did not do, hi, Gigi, is hit the You Just Lost a Listener, which goes along with what we were talking about earlier in the past 2 seconds.
You Just Lost a Listener.
Which one would you like to hear, John? We get a couple of them. One of them, they call us a racist, and the other one, they call us kind of a high and mighty jerks.
I like both.
Okay. We'll start off
I'll take racist for 500, Judy.
All right. Well, last week, Michael pretended to be a black interviewer. We have a little bit of that audio.
Michael Turley.
And this is an old.
This is very old.
His radio name is Turley.
Hi, dog. Big T here with my big dog, Sugar Shane. How you doing, man?
I'm doing great, man. Doing good.
Dog, all right. What's the 411 on your nickname?
Sugar Shane Mosley?
Yeah.
Oh, that happened when I was like 9 years old.
Okay.
Wow, you're like little Sugar Ray. We're going to call you Sugar Shane. From then on, I was Sugar Shane.
Okay, so man, what else?
So you get the idea. This is from Sarah Ferguson in California. Can't believe y'all are laughing about some stupid idiot putting on a black accent and talking ghetto to a sports guy. It's childish, and honestly, it's racist. Is you sound like one of those Amos and Andy bits from back in the Jim Crow days.
No, it doesn't.
Would it be so funny if black people came up there and started interviewing you? Howdy, howdy, you white folks. Have you roped any cattle today? Y'all need to grow up and see that you're hurting people. Happy Juneteenth, by the way. Mm-hmm. Sarah Ferguson from Downey, California.
You just lost a listener.
Okay. My response to that is I have a real live black person in the studio with me right now. And I have a real live white person that thinks they're black. They identify as black here in the studio. Pre-K.
Holla back.
Okay. So would y'all interview me and make fun of me?
Yeah. How? Oh, no. You write my checks.
No. I don't write your checks. Cindy writes your checks.
Well, yeah, how's the goat herding coming, man?
The goat herding? Well, I mean, it's not the goat herding. It's coming. It's going good. Thank you. What else you got?
Oh, man, I don't know, man. You know, yeah, what's some stereotypes for you, John?
He took him up. No, you're doing the interview. I'm the guy.
Mm. How are you celebrating Juneteenth, John?
Oh, I almost said something was going to be good. That would have got me in trouble.
See, you won't be getting you in trouble.
Now, Juneteenth is, Gigi, how am I celebrating
Juneteenth? Juneteenth is the time that it took for the slaves to find out that they were actually free. So they celebrate it. You know what I mean? And it's actually really big in Texas. So that's kind of awesome. What are you doing for Juneteenth today?
It started in Texas.
Yeah. Pre-K, what are you doing for Juneteenth this week?
Same.
I didn't ask Pre-K. I asked you.
Me? I have no plans.
Yes, you.
I know I won't be going to the bank to cover any checks because it's closed. And I will be working like normal and, just nothing really different. I work on holidays. But besides Christmas and New Year's Day and Thanksgiving, those are the three holidays I take off.
4th of July, too. Mm-hmm.
I really don't take off on the 4th of July.
Really?
I take off a little bit. Mm. I mean, aren't we open half the day on 4th of July?
No, we're closed on 4th of
July. We used to be. You son of a bitches, you lazy bastard.
It's 4th of July.
See, this is what happens when you let somebody else run your deal.
Wow. 4th of July, Christmas Day, yeah. New Year's Day, and Thanksgiving. That's it.
Okay, 4th of July.
Yeah.
From open to noon, you're open. Noon afterwards, you're out. The next day is when you celebrate 4th of July, because that's what's so ridiculous about 4th of July. You get drunk. You stay up until it's pitch-ass black dark so you can see the fireworks, right? Then you got to get up early and go to work. No, 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 no. That's not the way that should work. 4th of July should start at noon and end at noon the next day. Report to work. America listening right now. It's official. Just like Juneteenth is a holiday, it's a new holiday. We're doing it right now. 4th of July starts at ends at noon the next day.
Okay.
I'll take it. I'll take it. All right. That works. Yeah.
And our next, you just lost the listener. You've been talking about our history, how we got here to this beautiful studio on your ranch. Okay, well, this is from Earl Gilbert in Houston. You guys think you're all high and mighty now that you're in that castle in the country, huh? Huh? What happened to your show, man? Back in the day, you guys were some natty light slamming badasses, but now you sound like a Michelob Ultra type.
Oh.
Have fun on your golf carts and your golf course, Richie Rich.
I don't have a golf course. I don't have a golf cart.
Earl Gilbert in Houston, Texas.
Yeah.
You just
well, he's not invited
listener.
To the cookout.
Right. He's not coming out to play with the goats.
That's
what are you,
right.
What are you doing on... Just screw him. That guy's a moron.
Right.
God, I don't even have a response for that. oh, I can't air my response for that. GG, what... So let's talk about this Juneteenth thing.
Yes.
So are you working on Monday?
Yeah.
See, you're working on
Monday. I got to pay for my kids' college, so I'm working Monday.
So you're slave
Sunday,
to the slave to the dollar.
Yeah, you know what I mean? The greenback dollar.
I'm ready to be free to that.
He's not a hater. He's a Texan. Well, he's the accidental racist.
So you really are working on Juneteenth and you're black now? Why don't you take it off?
Because
they
I
should pay you. It should be a day with pay, shouldn't it?
I mean, if it was a day with pay, I probably still wouldn't take it off because then I could make double money.
Bingo. Charlie, that's why we're open on 4th of July.
Exactly.
We are open Monday, so.
Oh, okay. Well, then I'm all screwed up. I thought Monday was Juneteenth.
It is.
It is.
Okay.
And we're open, and so that's the same thing. They get paid.
So those black guys, that family, the two brothers and the sister that are from Britain that work for us.
Correct.
Are they taking the day off, or do they even recognize Juneteenth because they're European?
Well, everybody's working.
Is it around the world thing or just an America thing?
I don't think it's that kind of holiday.
It's a federal holiday in America.
Oh, it is?
Yes.
Do Jamaicans take off Juneteenth?
No.
Why not?
It's about because it's when the slaves in Texas found out that they were free, which took 2 years.
Is it a
years.
Texas holiday?
Yes. Well, it's a national holiday, but it's about what happened in Texas.
It started as true? A Texas holiday.
That's
correct. I think it's true, but I didn't know that it was a federal holiday.
Yes.
That's news to me. Yeah, I thought it was just a everybody get together barbecue holiday.
No.
We need more of those.
Yeah, we really do.
Is Christopher Columbus Day, did it get whacked?
Yeah, it's National Indigenous Peoples Day.
What's that mean?
It's Indigenous Peoples Day.
Define indigenous people to me, please.
Like the people who are indigenous to America, the Native Americans. It's Indigenous Peoples Day, right? They changed it from Christopher Columbus Day because he was a savage.
So it's Indian Day?
No, because that would imply that people from India would be celebrating. So it's Indigenous Peoples Day.
There are American Indians as well.
You just said a Native Americans.
No, they're not Indians.
Yes, they
they're
are.
Native Americans, oh, not Indians.
What's the difference?
There's a big difference.
Where's
because
Dan Snyder from
Indian.
The Washington Redskins when you need him?
They're not the Redskins anymore.
I know it. They're the Washington
no?
Football
what are they
Club.
Now?
They're the
Commanders.
Yeah, they should have left that alone. That doesn't even sound real.
I want to hear more about this Juneteenth thing. You're the only black girl here. Now, you need to speak up and get a little clearer.
Well, what do you want to know? Like,
I
want to
know
time.
Why you're working and why you're not planning something and why are you not celebrating this? Why are you,
well,
why are you skipping it? Why are you so high and mighty?
I celebrated every day that I am able to work and fund my daughter's college education.
Amen.
All right.
Hey, I got something to celebrate, John.
What?
My son, William Joel Brown, turns 24 years old today.
There
Happy birthday, son.
Oh,
I love
congratulations.
You.
Happy birthday.
Mark in Temecula, California.
Temecula!
What you got?
Good morning. I just wanted to say how much I love this show, and I wish you guys were on more than just 3 hours out here.
Hey, Otto and Keith, are y'all listening? They own the station. Go to their website and start a riot. Tell them to add the extra hour. Because they could. Why don't they do it? What I mean, is Journey and Elton John better than this? Mark?
Oh, I'm sorry, brother. I can hardly hear you.
Oh, good.
He said, is Journey and Elton John better than this?
Nothing's better than the John Clay Wolf Show.
That's right. You heard it here first.
800-800-7234. 800-800-RADIO. When we come back, we're going to try to do the car segment, even though the phones are kind of half-assed this morning.
Hey.
Yeah, it's a little drunk. The engineer, the studio engineer is drunk. Year, make, model, miles. Year, make, model, miles. Average, rough, or clean. Call in right now. 800-800-RADIO. 800-800-RADIO. 800-800-7234. Year, make, model, miles. Call in with your car. I'll bid it and buy it on behalf of GiveMeTheVIN.com, America's best car buyer. If Give Me the VIN does not beat a written CarMax offer, we'll send you a check for $100. Had people call in plenty of times. We beat CarMax by $6,000. We beat them by $2,000. We beat them by $3,000. Sometimes we're wrong. We're like, let them have it. We'll send them a check for $100. And it saves us a couple of grand. But the only thing that you're going to get if you want to shop us, Give Me the VIN against CarMax, is you're either going to get $100, period, more, $500, $1,000, $2,000. You're going to win. People want to win. You can win at Give Me the VIN. Yeah. GiveMeTheVIN.com. Be right back.
Heard on the air every Saturday morning from New York to Los Angeles to Houston and broadcasting to the rest of the world online at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolf.com. You're listening to The John Clay Wolf Show. Want more of The John Clay Wolf Show? Check out the largest radio show and fastest growing podcast at jcwshow.com.
Check. Hey, Mike, why don't you walk out on the patio so we can really see what it's like?
No, I can hear you.
Okay, you can hear me fine? Because earlier you were like, wow, it's loud and clear and crisp.
It's not as loud as the last one.
Why? Michelle, stay tuned. I'm going to take you first.
Thirty seconds. Stand by.
John Clay Wolf Show. Hit him up right now. 1-800-800-RADIO. This is the John Clay Wolf Show.
And this is where we bid cars on the radio for our sponsor, GiveMeTheVIN.com. Michelle, good morning. Are you there? Michelle, can you hear me?
I can hear you.
A 20 F-150 V6 STX, 53,000 miles, two-wheel drive crew cab. You owe $31,000, yes, but you want a bit more. Then you're not going to like me today. Yes.
Oh, okay.
Because I think the money's $28,000. I don't know it is. I don't think it is. I know it is.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
That's okay.
All right. Hang on. Who's this? Marsha in Louisiana. Good morning. Marsha.
Hey. John Clay.
Yes, ma'am.
Hey, John Clay. How are you today?
I'm good.
Great. I was calling because you are still breaching some of our notes. You made me mad the other morning. I called in because I was lining up to say something about Kid Rock. But I just wanted to let you know that even though you make me mad, I still listen to you every Saturday morning because it's the best damn radio show I've ever heard.
Thank you for all that you do.
It's like Bobo's character there.
Right. Richard, Florida.
Yes, I'm here.
What you got?
Hey, John, I just want to say that I can still see Turley's bald spot through his hat because I have X-ray vision, and I can definitely guarantee that Jeezy's breasts are definitely uneven.
Okay, so you're watching us on the video stream at jcwshow.com.
Oh, yeah. I'm in Florida, so you're off the air.
Oh, yeah.
I got the live feed.
The time zone jump. All right, thank you. Speaking of Gigi's breasts, will you go out with the Gigi Breast song that the listener sent in? Do you have it handy?
Yeah.
All right. Put that up here. And we'll be back in a second. Nah, you can't. It's not working. You can't find it.
Yeah, it's not playing.
That's
weird, yeah. Anyway.
All right, well, we'll do it when we come back. Name's John Clay Wolf, by Cars and Radio for America's Best Car Buyer. GiveMeTheVIN.com.
Yeah, some people say syndicated shows aren't that good because they don't have that local feel.
Right.
But you don't skyrocket to the number one weekend spot by sucking. Hey, the largest radio show and fastest growing podcast, The John Clay Wolf Show. Go to jcwshow.com.
30 seconds.
Benjamin Orr? Yes.
I believe so, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Sunday night. Speaking of, ironically, we haven't done Backtracks yet, and we have the Cars this week.
Oh, boy!
Oh, boy. All right, on this day in 1978, one of America's most influential new wave groups of the 70s and 80s, the Cars, first appeared on the charts with their debut single, Just What I Needed. It was first of many hits from the group from Boston, Mass.
Boston, Mass. We're going to get in the Cars. We're going to make us a rock album. We're going to call it the Cars. And when we sing, we're not going to sound like a bunch of Yankee pricks.
Bunch of target shoppers.
Bunch of target shoppers.
Target shoppers.
Okay. So guys that are Cars heads, 800-800-7234, 800-800-7234. Start calling in now because you know the drill. We're going to play these two songs backwards and you're going to tell me what they are. And if you are correct, you're going to win all the swag.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy. Cut one. It's not going to work. I mean, you know, we only spent a gazillion dollars on this. Okay, so let's do this again. We're going to play these two songs backwards. Charlie, turn it up a little bit. And you guess what these two songs are. 800-800-7234, 800-800-RADIO. That's a good one, Bob. A real Cars head can pull it out, but it's difficult. One more time. Okay, that's number one. Number two. Use your mouse. That's easy.
Yeah.
If you know it.
Not a hit song. That's one of those album cuts that radio just insisted on playing all
it's
the time.
It's one of the best.
It's one of my favorites.
Hit it again. One more time. Okay, cut one is this. Cut two is this. While we're waiting for you to call in with the answers, Gigi, let's go through the news. What's in the news, darling? Okay, not babe. So not babe.
Not da-
Can't okay. call you babe. Just okay. darling.
Okay, so there is an emu running loose in Texas.
Getting that mic loud as you can, your little light.
There's an emu running loose in Texas. Have you guys seen the emu in some place called Raines County?
No, I haven't seen the emu in Raines County. Next story.
Well, yeah, there's an emu in Raines County running loose, and the sheriffs are trying to identify the owners of the animal and get him. So if you see an emu, please turn him in.
If you can. Those suckers are mean.
I mean, well, okay, okay. There's also there is a Reddit user who goes by the name of... who goes by the name of Fairmoose4755, whose wife was angry with him because he was teaching his daughters how to gut a fish. He says, and I quote, "If you're going to eat the fish, you need to learn how to gut them." You've got daughters, or you've got a daughter, so would you teach your daughter how to gut a fish?
Of course I would, because God knows I don't want to do it.
Okay.
I teach her once, and every time she's with me, she's the one that gets to gut the fish.
Yeah, it can be an important life skill.
I mean, it's pretty simple. You take you cut its head off, and then you slit it down the gut, pull all the stuff out, then you're good. Wash it out. I mean, that's dumb.
And you got to scale them too, right? That little.
You can.
Depends on the fish.
Unless you're Mexican, and if you're Mexican, you leave the head on.
Only you could find a way to make it racist.
That's not racist. That's fact, babe. Have you never been to a real Mexican restaurant? Not the Texican, not the half-ass deal, but the real one. They put their fish on whole. They gut them, but they leave the head on.
Filipino foods, they do that too. That's good. All right. That's really good.
But look at you trying to make it Filipino racist. Golly, Gigi. You need to go back to mass.
Okay. So let me ask you guys something. How much is a million pennies worth? You know my math facts are not strong.
It's like $10, isn't it?
Okay, well this guy, John Reyes in Los Angeles, he found a million pennies in a house that he was restoring his father-in-law's house, and he's having trouble getting rid of them. The banks don't want them and they're very heavy to move, so I guess if someone would help him, they might be able to get part of that $10.
What is a million pennies?
That's what I'm asking. What's a million pennies?
You pulled the story. You should have the number before you got on it. That's called prep, darling.
It's in the thousands, right? $10,000?
$10,000.
Thank you.
Oh, $10,000?
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
We've got this Asian gal in the, this Vietnamese gal in the studio with us. She does math really well.
Okay, I would definitely help him.
Okay.
Yeah.
For $2,000, dude. Well, I'll buy your million pennies for $2,000. I wonder what it looks like, though. A million pennies would fit in a truck bed? No idea.
They had trouble transporting it because it was so heavy when they tried to put it in the truck bed. It weighed it down, and the banks don't want to deal with it. So,
well, you know what fixes problems, Gigi?
What?
Money. Give them some of it.
Give me some of it. Well, I'll help.
If you just tell the bank, I'll give you $1,000 of it.
You think so? They don't want it. They got too much money. They don't need that $1,000, but I do.
Okay, next.
Okay. The woman declared dead. She was not quite dead.
What are you talking about? Whoa. You just jumped. What woman declared dead?
Okay. Well, there's a woman. Her name is Gilberto Barbara Montoya.
Okay.
And they were having her wake. And while they were having her wake, they heard tapping on her coffin.
Oh.
And they opened the coffin to discover that she was still alive. She's in critical condition, but she's still alive. So there is that.
Golly.
Wow.
I mean, how would you feel if you were at a funeral or a wake and the person sat up or the person wasn't dead?
They bury her like right away, like, oh, she's dead. Okay, get the coffin. Let's throw her in real quick and start the funeral.
I've heard of that happening. Now, where was this?
It was a five-hour wake in Ecuador.
There you go.
And the person
it's always
said,
those South American countries that can't get this straight. I mean, if you're going to kill somebody, you got to kill them dead.
Well, one of the wake goers, whatever you call them, funeral people,
right,
said it gave us quite a fright.
Oh, no.
It scared the hell out of them. You know what I mean?
What else you got?
Well, what else do I have? There's crowds of visitors who traveled to Missouri that there was a nun there. Her name was Wilhelmina Lancaster.
Okay.
She died 4 years ago. And I forgot why they had to exhume her, but when they exhumed her body, she was perfectly preserved. And she wasn't embalmed. And so people are going, which I think is kind of gross. I don't know if she looks black because she's kind of decayed or she was black. But people are going to touch her and get dirt from the place where she was buried because they say that, you know, it's a miracle and she should be a saint. So if you have some free time, go to Missouri and touch a dead nun.
So what year did she die, does it say?
She died in 2019.
That's not that long.
But it's 4 years and she wasn't embalmed and she's perfectly preserved. She doesn't even look like a mummy.
Yeah, but it takes a while for your body to... And especially if it's in a good area where it's not a lot of humidity and stuff.
Is it near Dollywood?
Well, she's at Dollywood's in someplace else,
Pigeon
not
Forge
Kansas, right?
Is where that
not
is.
Missouri. Right?
Dolly has big boobs. Are they real?
I bet you hers match. I bet you hers are even.
I bet
this
are.
Is some ADD. A dead nun to Dolly's boobs.
Right.
Well, I mean, it all kind of works. You know what I
mean? I agree.
See,
this is what Gigi
and I get
along. I'm
praying for symmetry.
You're praying for
and
symmetry. Speaking of,
I'm
for symmetry. Do you have that song of the of Gigi's uneven boobs? Use your mouse. Use your words.
I'm so excited. I love that he did that.
Gigi.
Sounds like me.
Well, you're so cool.
No, it doesn't.
A sexy voice on the air making all of us guys drool. Gigi. Oh, my sweet hun, it's fine that one boob's a little bigger than the other one. If you ask me, you're just as fine as you can be with right a D and left a C. G-G.
There you go, G.
I love it. I feel so special.
You have fans out there. Okay. Now,
I need to make that my ringtone.
Send it to her. Okay. So we played these two cuts from the Cars. We have people lined up to guess what the two songs are, the actual titles of these songs. Play cut one, boss. All right. That's one, two. Blake in Long Beach, California. Good morning.
The Dangerous Type and Just What I Needed.
Dangerous Type is one of them, but Just What I Needed is not. Dave in Temecula, California.
Let's go Dangerous Type and Drive.
No, Dangerous Type is correct. Drive is incorrect. Tom in Arizona, good morning. You're on the air.
Dangerous Type and Nightlife.
Dangerous Type is correct. Nightlife is incorrect. So play Dangerous Type so we can get that out of the way.
That's number two.
The Dangerous Type. Do you have it forward?
Tonight, she's a lot like you. The Dangerous Type.
All right, so we have no winners on this. Play the other one backwards. Everybody knows it's Dangerous Type. Play the other one backwards, then y'all call in after this break. 800-800-7234. 800-800-7234. 800-800. It spells out radio on your touch tone phone. 800-800-7234. You know Dangerous Type. Do you know this one? That's easy. That was the easy one.
Yeah, that chord,
one,
man.
One more time. Right before I go to break, I'm going to try it. Las Vegas, you there?
Yeah, how's it going, John?
Good, good.
Hey, the A's are an iconic name, you know. We just inherited an iconic name, you know, so.
Baba, I'm telling you.
It can't be Oakland because it's Vegas.
We were talking.
Vegas at Las Vegas A's.
We were talking earlier about the A's and moving to Las Vegas. I'm telling you, Bob, they're still running on delay. There's no question. Will you write this down? Call Las Vegas. Tell them to take the effing delay off. They don't need it anymore.
Gotcha.
Thank you. Okay, because that was 3 hours ago.
That was 9 months ago.
No, when you talk to him. But yeah, you have to.
No, we've been talking to him.
But
for
you have
nine
to follow
months.
Up and have somebody stream it live and make sure it's
fly
happening.
Me out there and I'll fix it.
Right. Chris, good morning. Do you have the answer real quick before we bump?
Let the good times roll and Dangerous Type.
There you go.
Thank
boy.
You, Chris. You won.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Free cars, music.
I don't know what you won.
Records.
Do you really even want to win anything? Let the good times roll. Okay, Chris, we're going to put you on hold. Pre-K, send Chris the stuff since he lives in Oklahoma. Make him pay the shipping. Yeah, I'm like that. Chris?
Show.
All right, thanks. We'll be right back. My name is John Claywolf. Buy cars on the radio for America's best car buyer. Give me the VIN, VIN.com.
This is the John Clay Wolf Show.
Get a haircut, buttercup.
America's largest weekend morning show, 800-800-RADIO. Check out the podcast at jcwshow.com or johnclaywolf.com. Hey, the largest radio show and fastest growing podcast, the John Clay Wolf Show.
James, I'm not gonna say about the prick deal because they'll get all pissy, so I'm not gonna take it there. And Mary Jo, we're past Juneteenth, but I do appreciate you calling, so I'm gonna dump both of y'all. Thanks.
It's worked so far, but we're not out yet.
I wanna know what you're thinking. There are some things you can't hide. I wanna know what you're feeling. Tell me what's on your mind.
We'll be right back.
Yo, we're back to the John Clay Wolf Show, presented by GiveMeTheVin.com. Check out the fastest growing podcast at JCWShow.com.
Morning, everybody. So, at the end of this segment, we're going to lose some of you guys in the central time zone, in the mountain time zone. We'll have another hour in the west time zone. And then at the end of today, around 2 o'clock, we put up the podcast of the whole show with the music and the commercial breaks stripped out. A lot of people like to do that during the week, commuting back and forth. Because we do 4 live hours on Saturday morning, which we are right here. It is Father's Day weekend. Happy Father's Day, fathers, to all of you fathers. Do we have a comedic clip on fathers?
We do, actually, while we're on the subject of fathers and kids. This is Roy Wood Jr. This will be cut number 7, Mike. His dissertation on dads that have way too many kids. Cut 7.
That's the hustle in this country. You don't want to pay for childcare, have all your kids in a group, and just take them on TV. Look at all these babies we had at one time. And people give you money, they give you snacks, they call the number and everything. I don't give money because most people that have that many kids at once, it's because they have fertility, or they took fertility pills, which is fine. You want to take a pill to have a kid, fine, take a pill. But if you have more kids than you can afford to keep, ha ha, not my fault. Don't get on TV begging for snacks. First of all, why do you have to keep all the kids? Where is that a written rule? You just met them kids. Pick 2 or 3. You don't know these kids. Just, I don't know. I don't know which baby to keep. Let America vote. Put the kids on TV and put a number and let Craig Robinson host it. Welcome back to Last Baby Standing. I'm just saying, it's a double standard in America because we only care about groups of kids that are in need if they're all wearing the same shirt. 6 kids at one time, you get free stuff from Oprah. 6 kids, 5 different men, you're on Maury Povich for a paternity test.
Happy Father's Day, everybody.
Happy Father's Day.
You have another one if you want it.
What is it?
John Heffron talking about some of the things that dads do. It'll be cut number 17, Mike.
I don't know what kind of swing set you guys had growing up, but my swing set sucked. Right? Because my dad put it together for us, and every time we swung on it, one pole would come right out of the grass. Because your dad would do such a crap job cementing it in. You'd actually swing on it, then see the swing set above you. You're like, what? Bees and wasps would always come out of that top tube. Well, I'm getting gas, his dad pulls up, and you can tell the guy's on vacation because he's got all these big dad veins popping out of his face. He's in this SUV. His kids stay in the far back. One kid is playing a video game. The other kid is flipping through satellite TV. And the whole time I'm thinking, holy crap, people, can you imagine what it'd be like traveling with your own family in that situation? Could you imagine being so far back from your dad that he couldn't smack you at any given time? I hope kids are just taunting their dads from back there. Hey, Dad, we just spilled something. Car company should make a hand that goes on the seat in front of the kid that just goes like that. Dad could have a little button he hits. Pop, 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 pop. What?
Little Father's Day humor. Hey, we were doing the Cars Candio intro a minute ago, and it resonated with a man named Larry in Beverly Hills, California. Larry, are you there?
I am here, John.
So the naked chick, the naked gal on laying on the Corvette on the cover of the Candio album is a friend of yours?
It's a Ferrari.
Is a Ferrari. You're right. It was a Daytona.
Her name is her name's Nancy Bibb. That's what she went by. She was working for Hugh Hefner at Pips in Beverly Hills, and Alberto Varga, the guy who did all the pinups, came with his grandniece, and they sketched her. And then when they said they wanted her to do it nude, she didn't do nudes. So they said they'll find somebody else. But they used the picture that he sketched, and she never got credit for it. Never got paid for it, nothing.
Huh. Did they make her prettier? Was she that good looking in real life?
Repeat that, please.
Was she that attractive in real life, or did they make her better looking on the sketch?
She's still that attractive. She is still that attractive.
You're a little hung up on the scale, Larry.
She's beautiful. I am a little hung up on her, yeah.
Well, let's call her. Do you have her phone number? Let's call her right now on the radio.
Well, she's probably still in bed. You know, those Hollywood types. I can make arrangements for that if you'd like.
Next Saturday, I would love to talk to the lady that is on the cover of the Candio album. So do you live in Beverly Hills?
I appreciate it so very much.
Do you live in Beverly Hills?
Pardon me?
Do you live in Beverly Hills?
I've been staying with her. I've been staying with her for the last 6 months because she's had some health problems, but she's doing better.
All right.
I actually live in Long Beach, California.
All right. Small world.
I've known her for 10 years. It's October 5th.
We'll talk to her
and
next.
And yes, I am hung up on her.
Good. I don't blame you.
Okay. Thank you,
next
John.
Saturday, she'll be on the air with us, per Larry.
Far out.
You better watch out, Larry. Them hot redheads, man. It'll screw you up and take all your money, Larry.
Watch out, the redhead Larry.
Okay, rewind. What's it called? Flashback. What are we doing?
Viral flashback. Yeah.
Viral flashback. So a viral moment in our life that we're going to flashback to. And this is Antoine Dodson.
It's like 12 years ago, Turley brought this up this week. He said, you remember that guy? I was like, what guy? I looked up. Oh, yeah.
Terrifying moments for a woman who woke up to a strange man in bed with her. The woman screamed. Her brother rushed in to help and tried to fight the offender off. Elizabeth's emotions were running high.
And Mark, the woman, the victim, tells us that a man broke into her house and tried to rape her. Her brother ran to help.
Obviously, we have a rapist in Lincoln Park. He's climbing in your windows. He's snatching your people up, trying to rape them. So y'all need to hide your kids, hide your wife, and hide your husband because they're raping everybody out here.
The attacker got loose and went out the upstairs window, but he did leave something behind.
We got your T-shirt. You left fingerprints and all. You are so dumb. You are really dumb. For real.
Dodson says he's never seen the perp before, but sends this warning to whoever is responsible.
You don't have to come and confess that you did. We're looking for you. We going to find you. I'm letting you know now, so you can run and tell that homeboy.
And overnight, this guy is an internet sensation.
Well, this group made a song about it, of that video clip, and it was wonderful. It's one of the best songs ever written.
Yeah, the Gordon Brothers.
He's slamming in your windows. He's snatching your people up, trying to rape them. So y'all need to hide your kids, hide your wife, hide your kids, hide your wife, hide your kids, hide your wife, and hide your husband, because they're raping everybody out here. You don't have to call and confess. We're looking for you. We gon' find you. We gon' find you. So you can run and tell that. Run and tell that. Run and tell that. Homeboy. Homeboy.
We got your T-shirt to the left
fingerprint. Right. You are so dumb.
You are really dumb. For real. The man got away, leaving behind evidence. I was attacked by some idiot in the project.
So dumb, so dumb, so dumb, so dumb. He's climbing in your windows, he's snatching your people up, trying to rape them. So y'all need to hide your kids, hide your wife, hide your kids, hide your
wife. He got rich off of this.
It was a top 100 download, too. It's crazy on iTunes. But
yeah, and he got to do celebrity boxing with Kato Kaelin, yeah, and a reality show and a whole bunch of other stuff. So it worked for him.
Well, it didn't quite work as well for Bobo. Do you remember Bobo redid that song, too, made a country version of it?
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
I haven't heard this in... How many years ago was this?
12 years.
12
yeah.
years ago you
yeah.
did this, Bob.
Yeah.
Wow. Hit it.
Well, he's climbing through windows and snatching people up, trying to rape them. So hide on your kids. Hide the wife, hide the kids. Hide the wife and the kids. And hide your husband, because he's raping them all. You don't have to confess. We're looking for you. Gonna find you. So run and tell that to your homeboy. We got your T-shirt and fingerprints. You're really dumb for real. A dumb rapist down Lincoln Park. You don't have to confess. We're looking for you. Gonna find you. So run and tell that to your homeboys. So hide your wife and the kids. And don't forget to hide your husband, or they'll get raped by the rapist in Lincoln Park.
You and Gigi need to redo that as a duet.
That was great.
Gigi, you've never heard that, have you?
No, yeah. I love it, though.
Bob is a hell of a singer.
Yeah, he's got an excellent voice.
Well, I wasn't on that one, but sometimes I do all right.
But yes, you were. You have a great voice and great hair.
Guys, we've got to jump to a music break. We'll be back on the West Coast. We're going to lose some of you guys in the middle of America, so you can go to jcwshow.com and stream it live. Or just grab the podcast. It goes up at 2 o'clock. Remember, givemethevin.com is who this show is brought to you by. It's America's best car buyer. Give Me the VIN does not beat a CarMax offer. They'll send you a check for $100. Just go to givemethevin.com. Put in your stuff. It'll spit out a number. A buyer will contact you. Y'all negotiate the deal. We'll come to your house, bring you a check, wire you the money, however we want to do it, pay off your payoff, or you can bring it to one of our 40 locations at givemethevin.com.
The John Clay Wolf Show is heard every week on great stations like Oklahoma City's Rock 100.5 KATT, the legendary Cat Rocks, and Wilmington's 94.5 The Hawk, the Port City's classic hits. Stream us live online or pick up the country's fastest growing podcast at jcwshow.com and at johnclaywolf.com. And we'll be back with more of the John Clay Wolf Show right after this.